And we are coming down in 3, 2, 1.
Welcome to Getting Sports with Drunk. I'm your host, Cupcake the Riddler, questioning why there's a Jack Daniel's sign in the studio. I'm joined by
Mark,
Sheen Washable,
Nay,
Solzay,
the Maskers Massey,
and the Red Baron.
Tell you what, that burp stinks over here. Yeah, it's a rough one.
Wow.
Bob made meatloaf, so I'd just like to shout out the Red Baron. We're in the same shirt.
Yeah.
All right, now take him out.
I got a blue one in the bag.
I'm going to... What? You never wear our shirts.
I wear 10 shirts.
You don't wear our shirts.
I wear 10
shirts. You don't
wear
our shirts. You don't use the beer... Where's your beer journal? Who has Kyle's beer journal?
Mass has it now.
No, he doesn't.
No.
He's sitting over there with Kyle.
Oh. Give it to Mass. Let Mass use it.
You won't
ever use it. He doesn't promote our show. He doesn't do homework for the show. He doesn't buy tickets for us to go to sporting events.
Now he's just...
He sleeps in the car like a dog.
He's just being silly.
Like a dog.
But yeah, we're here on Drunk Monday. We should start recording. We should start doing 5-hour shows every day.
Ass is about to be real hammered. I don't know how he's getting home.
Well, carefully.
3 miles an hour in the right lane.
Which will probably be 60 miles an hour in the handicap lane.
The shoulder.
I thought there was a handicap lane. Matt, what are you drinking? What are you drinking?
Private stock.
So Matt is drinking private stock. So we have a very limited amount of beer on the show today. We have 2 people drinking the same thing and 3 people drinking the same thing.
But the 3 people are right.
What are the chances we can get Rebecca to not wear that raincoat? Because it's pretty distracting, all that movement that's going on.
Nylon City.
Yeah. You should get a striped sweater. The best time to wear a striped sweater
is all the time.
Is all the time. All right. So anyway, Mass, Chris Massey, Solzay, what are you guys drinking?
Drinking Juice Boost from Victory.
It's my beer.
It's your beer?
Mm-hmm. My company. Anything about it? What type of beer it is?
It's a sour.
Okay. All right. It's a dry hop sour.
No, just a sour.
No, it says dry hops on it. It says
right
on it.
Just a sour.
It's like, yeah, that's our beer. And goes, no.
The Red Baron, Machine Washable, and myself are all drinking a fine brew from the great land of Wisconsin.
Plank Road Brewery.
Milwaukee, Wisconsin, to be specific.
Ooh, Milwaukee's back. How you guys doing?
And we are drinking the uncommonly smooth Red Dog.
Woof, 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 woof.
Browns and Foe.
Oh, I love this beer.
Yeah, imagine if it was like an orange dog, though, like a brown dog. It was like the official beer of the Browns. But like only...
This could be.
Would you be a Browns fan?
Yeah.
If they, we would go to games if they had only this beer.
I tell you, I've been trying to get us all to go to a Browns game just because they were so cheap.
Not anymore.
I still want to go.
You just want to go see Odell.
I might buy his jersey.
Giants might be cheap tickets this year.
This is very true.
MetLife.
Yeah.
No shit.
They're not, but they might be.
It's like the Yankees. The Yankees could go 0-162 for 4 straight years. It would still be a lot of money to go to that game.
It'd still be $10 a soda.
Shout out to Adubo Herrera. Just had a 2-run ding dong.
So that's your toast of excellence.
Yeah, that's fine.
All right. Toast of excellence then. I have a few, so I'm going to rattle these off, try to do them in quick fashion. If I steal yours, get over it.
Well, I'd like to go so you don't steal mine.
No, nope,
that's
like not
to
how this works.
So you don't steal mine.
That's none of that works for you, gentlemen. All right, so mine is, this is kind of blasphemy, but it's one's to Blake Snell, starting off the season hot, and for Fox Sports putting up this amazing poster of Snellzilla, him cheering, and there's like planes flying around him.
It's pretty fun.
Yep. I also have one to Russell Westbrook, not only for averaging a triple double for the third consecutive season, but for having a higher percentage of like it's more. He has a higher percentage of him getting a triple-double in a game than he shot from the floor, which is pretty impressive. I thought that was pretty pretty cool. Also to Russell Westbrook for being the first person to put up a 20-20-20 stat line since Wilt. I also have one for Bob Cole retiring as the voice of hockey. Last game was between the Canadiens and the Maple Leafs. His hockey season's all wrapped up. He was the voice of hockey for like a very long time, like 50 years.
Wow.
Doing primetime games was pretty intense. And also to Kofi Kingston for just making Kyle cry last night.
He did.
Kyle cried.
Who did he beat?
It doesn't matter who he beat. Beat Daniel. He beat the real Daniel
Bryan. My toast, I'm going to piggyback kind of WWE here. Zack Ryder going out, winning a tag title last night at WrestleMania. He also got engaged recently.
Woo.
Woo.
Woo. Woo.
No. He's also going to lose that title tonight, but that's all right.
To like some like B squad, yeah. Too. Maybe yeah. A B team. Do you have a sports one? Like a non-WWE sports one?
No.
All right.
Zack Ryder, baby.
Mass, Chris Massey?
To Juju for keeping a level head through AB being a total cunt.
Right.
And minus Gary Carter, who would have been 65 years old today.
Also to Ryan Shazier. I don't know if anyone saw it, but he did a 2-foot box jump the other day.
Yeah.
Good for him, making
which
recoveries.
Which is higher of a box jump than I can do right now.
Or hey, Polanco hitting for the cycle.
You mean just yeah. Right now?
And also, on top of all of that, too, prayers and wishes to a speedy recovery for the Auburn gymnast. Anybody else
yeah.
See that?
No, I didn't see.
She
gruesome.
Did a floor routine, did like a triple front flip, landed on an angle going forward, so her knees went the other way, and she shattered both her legs.
Yeah.
Oh, this should be good.
It's so rough. It's
pretty much for that.
Her body was at about a 45-degree angle, and her knees went backwards and touched the floor.
Ugh. I'm going to go ahead and Google
yeah.
I found it already.
Is it
of course
online?
It's on. This is 2019.
Oh, here we go. Here it is. I want to see Max's reaction.
That's not okay.
No, yeah. It's bad.
That's not okay.
Yeah, it's
rough
terrible.
Rough
time.
Oh, fucking yeah, Christ.
Rough time for Auburn sports.
Fuck.
So I just wanted to sprinkle that in.
Toast him.
All right. I'm like kind of nervous about this.
Oh. I think I just found the 5-star.
Wow. Yeah,
that was rough watching that.
I like that.
Rebecca's like, yeah, it didn't faze me. I played softball.
I like that a lot.
Here, let me replay it for you real quick.
What do you mean, what do you do?
Look at her knees. Watch.
What do you mean, what do you
and
do?
And backwards.
Oh.
Yeah, dude, it's bad. Kyle can't hear, but his peripherals are fantastic. On a good day, he can see his ears.
Facts.
Good day, he can see his ears.
So she's what? I'm sorry, what was the question?
Hana?
Yeah, probably. She'll heal, but that's probably the most gruesome sports injury I've ever seen.
That's worse.
I
than
agree.
That's worse than the Louisville player from a couple years ago during the.
But worse than Sean Livingston. It's worse than Paul George.
It's up there with like Zach Miller's.
Yeah, that was. It's rough. I mean,
it's worse than Zach Miller's.
See the Pirates guy get nailed in the face today.
I just read that headline. Yeah,
and then lost 10-0.
102 mile per hour comeback to the face.
I've been
get
look,
your glove
late,
up, bro.
I've been saying for years, we need an automatic pitcher.
Like a machine?
Yep.
That'd be horrible.
An AI pitching machine. It throws 42 different pitches
really good.
At speeds varying from 60 to 110.
Oh my god.
Also, no strike zone. You have to swing at everything. It doesn't low, high, it doesn't matter. You get 3 pitches. You either hit them or you don't.
So does the machine get a jersey?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
0-0.
Well, it'll be riveted on the back. Every team will have one.
Riveted.
Yeah, it'll they'll all wear 42.
You have to keep pushing it on and off the field.
A what?
You have to keep pushing it on and off the field.
No, what's gonna happen is
home team provides.
Right. So it's gonna say like say it's the Phillies versus the Mets. So it'll be a riveted machine that'll say, you know, it'll say 42 and then it'll be whatever name you give it. And
give this guy a beer journal and he just rips it apart.
Oh, so this is what you do with it.
Right on the next page. I'm going to rip out the page. I want this to be my own.
That's so anyway, insulting.
So anyway, so it'll be, you know, just say it says Fanatic, and then it's in red riveting, and then when the Mets come out
riveted
defense,
for its pleasure.
It'll spin around, and it'll be in blue and orange, and it'll be riveted. I think you can't tell me that baseball wouldn't be a better sport without the likes of Kershaw and Syndergaard, DeGrom. They're all overrated. When's the last time you saw a pitcher bat over 300 with more than a dozen home runs?
Well, the pitching machine's not going to do that.
No, but I'm just saying that that's all they do is pitch. So you get something that all it does is pitch.
Mike Hampton.
I think you mean Casey Hampton.
Mike Cameron.
I think you mean Jordan Cameron.
Cameron Maybin.
Ooh, you know Cameron Meredith. I think you mean Cameron Diaz.
Ooh, great MLB player.
Mm, long legs. Anyway.
She had a fun time with the mask.
I can see Rebecca's computer. I'm going to watch Zack Ryder lose his belt. God damn it.
I'm getting cucked by WWE right now. Mask, do you have a This Day in Sports thing going on?
Yeah, I have one.
Oh, all right.
Not a whole lot happened.
What's your favorite color?
His favorite color? His favorite color is blue.
Red dog.
That's actually true.
I know that. That's why I said it.
Yours is
blue. Mox is blue. Kendall's is blue. And Kyle's is green.
What's yours?
Favorite color?
Purple.
Oh.
Mine's purple.
On April 10th in 1934, the Chicago Blackhawks beat the Detroit Red Wings 1-0 in a double overtime for a 3-1 series win, the Hawks' first Stanley Cup.
Well,
round the horn for that one. There round the go. Horn of Red Dog. No, no, no.
Red
no.
Dog. Nope, round the horn. He said it. Bring it out.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Don't touch my Red Dog. Hey. I don't have enough of them.
Oh, no.
It sounds like a goose when he does it.
Oh, no.
Usually he does that when Jeff's around.
Well, Jeff kept blaming him for the Phillies' loss because he wasn't putting enough energy in his hone now at the game. Because he'd be like, Kyle, say it. And Kyle's like, hone now.
He finally broke down. And
oh, yeah, we're at the Phillies game again this past weekend. They lost 6-2.
Correcto mundo.
6-2. It was a close game. Until the guys behind us, very funny, they said that the umps were... what was it? The umps were playing for Minnesota because the ball hit the foul pole, and that's clearly a foul ball, not a home run, that they were blind. So they've never been to a game.
Yeah, they were really
ever
irritating.
In their life. They also saw somebody on the Twins got hit by a pitch, and they were like, "Oh, they're just feeling sorry for him. Just, you know, this isn't how you play baseball." And it's like, it is how you play baseball.
Showed up in the fourth inning.
Yep.
I had the whole side to myself.
They showed up in the fourth inning, and two of the girls left in the fifth inning to go to the bathroom and came back in the eighth. So they were there for two innings of baseball.
What's up, Anthony?
What's up, dude?
That just goes to show you that one of them took a dump at the stadium.
Oh, yeah. the other one sifted through it.
Where's my ring?
No, it was for the nips that she ate. it was a good game, though. It was a little hot. Someone was right over us, but we were right next to the bullpen. I got to see Nishik warm up.
Yeah, some cool stuff got posted up on the page.
Yeah, we got to see Arrieta warm up before the game. Center for the Philadelphia Eagles, Jason Kelsey, was sitting two rows in front of us. His dad, also father of Travis Kelsey, handed me my tin.
That got away.
Kyle said, you know, just leave it. We'll buy another one. It was full. Nothing had been removed.
Money bag souls.
Well, no, it was just...
Daddy Souls Bucks over there.
I didn't want to interrupt Jason. He clearly didn't want to be seen.
Yeah, he was... I mean, he wore, like, a wig, like a curly Afro wig with, like, glasses and, like, a scarf.
So then what was the tip-off?
He said...
So a kid noticed him and asked him to sign his Eagles hat, and he did, and then the kid shouted from, like, 20 seats over, "Thanks, Jason Kelsey!"
Totally blew his cover.
And then we were just like, "That's Jason Kelsey."
I tell you, that's incredible to notice an offensive lineman.
Then a mob of people came over. A security guard was like, "No, no, no, he doesn't want to do this." And then the security guard got a picture with him. While the kids were standing there not getting a
That's
picture
very
with him.
Funny.
It's like a 90-year-old decrepit man. Also, Kendall put the moves on this old lady. It was pretty good.
Yeah, are you talking about Rebecca?
No.
I'm sorry.
Kendall, proud owner of a tattoo parlor in Enfield, Connecticut.
Yeah, the story kind of went like, I don't know, was it you or Jeff said? But you
Jeff, I was just relaying the message. We don't need to do this. This is all off-air shit. But it was a good time. You know, if you haven't been to a baseball game yet this season, I don't blame you. It's only 10 games. But you got like 150 left to go. Good.
Kyle's great at scheduling games to go.
If you're a Mariners fan, you only got about 140 left to go. So is he wearing a Mariners hat, actually? Or
Marlins.
Marlins, yeah. How is it that I always wear your team's hat and you wear every other team's hat?
Especially in your division.
Yeah.
I like it for the old school logo.
You like the new logo, too, though.
Die. I like it, but I'm not going to buy the hat.
Yeah, you will.
It's a matter of time. A lids is all you need.
Oh, yeah.
Hamburger Helper.
I'm going to go ahead and...
Hamburger Helper? So what do you got for us, Riddler?
Well, I figured we'll use that as a little segue. We talked a little bit, but... We're a week plus into the MLB season. Now, this isn't by any means the tipping point on how seasons are going to go for teams. But, you know, I wanted to do a quick little thing. You know, not quick. Doesn't have to be quick. Take your time. But so far, we're about what? Every team's about what? 10 games in, Kyle?
Yeah. More or less.
10-ish games in, somewhere on that mark?
Eight to 10, 12.
So 8 to 10 would be 10-ish.
The Mariners. Okay.
5, 6, right. 7, 8, 9, 10.
So, some teams have played. Some teams have played as well. But so what are some teams that so far have been real surprises, and what are some teams that have been disappointments?
Well, I'll just real quick. The obvious one is the Reds with a game one to this point. And not that there was high expectations, but there was a lot of moves that were made coming into this offseason, coming into the season. I guess I expected higher...
Two wins?
Higher, no, I just you know, more offensive showing, perhaps, I guess. But
I think it'll show up at some point. I mean, it's starting slow. I mean, like you said, expectations weren't high, but they were higher than expected. They'll get going at some point.
Yeah, they're only team with one win. Not that it matters, but it matters. I don't know who they won against. I don't remember.
I think, to me, the Red Sox have kind of been a surprise disappointment. I mean, they were coming off...
No, none of that. Just disappointment.
It's just... I mean, last year, they were dominant throughout the entire season. And, you know, they didn't really do anything in the offseason to help the team. They lost bullpen pieces, and it's kind of showing. I mean, even the starters, which are good, aren't pitching well. I mean, I'm sure at some point they'll figure it out, but right now they don't look that great, which is awesome.
Another disappointment for me are the Phillies, that they're not undefeated right now. It's an outrage to anyone who's a fan.
How about the Mets, though?
How about them Mets? Nah, they're right behind the Phillies there.
That's what they do every year.
Just wait till May ends.
Just wait. We're going to have a good May. Long season to go. How do you like your ACL, Torn?
I think a nice surprise is that, not the record-wise, but the play of the youth in Chicago.
Yeah.
I think Elhoy has been doing well. He got his first hit early in the season, and he's been putting in some RBIs. Moncada's been on an absolute fucking tear.
Yeah.
They lost the series, I think, 2-1 to the Mariners, but, like, Tim Anderson went, 10 for 13 with, 6 runs scored, 4 RBIs and 2 home runs, and Abreu's been on a fucking absolute stroke of the bat, so he's really helping the trade value out for the White Sox when that time comes around, because...
Which seems to,
be every year thing.
Every year.
It's an every year thing. But Jose Abreu, Jordan Howard, it's all the same. We finally pulled the trigger on one, so the other one's coming. But I don't know. I was surprised at how good of a start these younger guys on the team, the people that everyone's excited for, have gotten off to a good start. Not Kopech. That guy's sitting at home, nursing an elbow. Dries is going to have a fucking dynamite year next year. And then it'll be average the rest of it.
I'm surprised with how bad the Nationals have been. I knew they weren't going to be fantastic, but I didn't think they would.
I still think the Nationals are not even, I wouldn't even say a dark horse, but I think they're a candidate to still win the division.
They don't really have the offensive firepower.
No, but they have absolutely elite pitching. They have the pitching rotation to all they need is one or two runs.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, everyone's going to have bad days, but I could see it. If the Phillies go on a slump, or if the Mets play any baseball after May. You know,
when they wrap up.
The Mets have been lobbying for a real quick two-month World Series. Can we do like a quarter way through the season postseason, and then we'll play the rest of it out?
Yeah, but Riddler is right. The Nationals could go on a tear. After Philadelphia, they have Pirates, and then the Giants, and then the Marlins. So if they can pick up some ground there, we'll see. And then the Rockies. That nice thin air in Denver.
It's a nice surprise, too. I mean, we all know that the season started and the Yankees were dropping like flies to the injured list.
They're the real New York team now.
I mean, really, within the first couple days, I mean, Stanton, Severino, Andujar, gone. So, I mean, a lot of teams you lose. Those are three big pieces on the Yankees team. And most of the time, if you lose three big names like that, you're going to skid for a while, but the Yankees have depth, which has been nice. I mean, they're still winning games without those guys.
We'll save that.
Clint Frazier.
It's fun playing Baltimore.
Is insane.
Yeah. We'll save that topic for hot takes.
Well, my biggest surprise this year is the Seattle Mariners.
Yeah.
Making their 90th trade of the last 4 years.
Hey, you make enough of them, they got to end up working out for you, right?
Well, they don't have any like real pitching, but they're just hitting bombs. Tim Beckham, Domingo Santana, Jay Bruce. They just have a bunch of guys that were good. Or Santana is still young. He just didn't have a spot for him in Milwaukee.
Right.
But, you know, he's starting to show his promise. And Ryan Healy batting eighth for that. That's pretty insane. He was a six-hitter for Oakland, a five-hitter. You know? I mean, they're going to suck because their pitching's ass. And Felix isn't the same. But it's a nice little surprise to start off the year.
Surprised that the Astros are only at 500.
No, they'll be fine.
To Zach Ryder. He didn't lose his belt tonight.
They just won. They just won? Who'd they beat?
The same team.
The Revival?
Yeah. Another.
The Nationals are playing 500 ball.
Another team that's a disappointment is Colorado. They only have 6 home runs as a team. Where, you know, you think of the Rockies, you think they should have 20 about now. Arenado has none.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's interesting, and we may have touched on this a long time ago. I never think to look at where they rank at, like, home run as a team at the end of each year. I feel like for a very favorable ballpark to hit home runs, they never end up being, like, the number one team, you know, as a home run leader. And it's funny that it happens that way. I'm sure it has happened in the past, but...
Imagine the Yankees lineup there.
Yeah, I was just thinking that.
Imagine with their 700th home run this year.
Imagine anybody's lineup there.
Yeah. And we're only halfway through the season.
Colorado.
The Yankees playing in Colorado.
Yeah. Imagine just a bunch of power pole hitters playing at the Polo Grounds.
Another surprise is San Diego's pitching staff. They're coming out firing. Can't say the guy's name, but like Joe Luisi, 2 starts, has yet to give up an earned run. They're keeping him in the games.
Anthony's agreeing with you. Anthony on Facebook said the team out west to watch is the Padres.
Padres aren't doing too bad right now.
They spent money on the lineup. I mean, if the pitching comes through, they can make noise.
They have a low-key, really good lineup. You got Fernando Tatis, who came up. They decided to put him on the roster. Really good so far.
It's not even really low-key. I mean, they signed Machado. They signed Hosmer. They've spent money
they
on guys.
They have Will Myers.
Don't sleep on Austin Hedges now.
But I mean, they've spent money on their lineup,
that's
so I mean...
bullshit, because Mejia should be starting. They drafted him for that reason. And played 2 games.
I think it's just a fluke that will...
No.
You don't think so?
Hedges is good with the pitching staff. But, anyway.
But yeah, so far, I mean, there's been a lot of exciting baseball. I mean, we've already had the first fight.
Big fight.
We versus the world.
It's so funny. He just comes running out.
They had like a meme out. I don't know if it was like the referencing 300 or whatever. I don't know if you guys saw that. Just, no.
Say it again?
Never mind. It wasn't that good.
I was reading what Anthony wrote on Facebook. What did you say?
No, there was a meme. I'm referencing 300 or something, but it's Puig and then like the entire like you know Persian army like against him.
Another like a player surprise. I know he won the MVP last year, but Yelich is putting up ridiculous power stats this year. He has 5 home runs, I think. He has like 6 doubles.
Well, he's doing what he was anticipated to do all along, I think.
Yeah. He finally fit into his body, which is weird to say, but like when he was in Miami, he was still skinny and not built to be the home run guy.
You know what though? It's interesting when you see like Yelich was a guy in Miami that we thought would be good, but never I don't think what he is now. And it's great to see a guy get into like the right situation. You know, he went to a Brewers team that embraced him and he kind of grew into this superstar role and is just enjoying it.
Right.
You know, it wasn't something that when he came up, it was put upon, you know, almost like when Trout, Harper, when those guys came up, like they were forced into that superstar, which they've played well with it. But Yelich just kind of stumbled into it and is just rolling with it.
And Yelich was the bottom feeder out of the three in Miami. You know, they went Stanton, Ozuna, Yelich. I mean, right, he'd been having better seasons than both of them, quote unquote. I don't think Stanton's overall better hitter, but
so far, I mean, it's been a year.
You know what I'm saying?
No, I know, but it's been a year. But you're right. Yelich has been playing great baseball. I mean, it carried over from last season.
The Phillies could have had him.
Of course they could have, Kyle.
Yep, they could have. And they said no.
Here, Pete Rose is coming out of retirement, play for the Phils again.
It's too bad that the freaking Bluefish are gone. No celebrity.
Are they gone?
They're gone. They're building in the amphitheater there.
Me and a guy at work were talking about that today, and he said that, and I was like, oh, I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm. It's a huge project. I don't know.
You said they're opening up an empanada theater?
Yes. No, empanada. I don't know when it's going to be done, but like outdoor concerts and all that, that's kind of the goal.
Yeah, that'll make a lot of money.
We'll see.
Who's going to play that?
I don't know.
Who's going to play an outdoor venue in Bridgeport?
I think it's supposed to be like a... not up and coming artists, that's not the right thing. But it's a smaller venue.
Yeah, I gotcha. Never know. Kyle's gonna play.
Maybe we'll play there.
I already said that.
Did you put a band together?
We'll broadcast. We'll have instruments. But we'll...
Can I have the tambourine?
If you must.
It's funny because none of us play an instrument. Just be nonsense.
Took a recorder in like the third grade.
Played trombone for a couple weeks.
I can play the guitar serviceably.
Oh, so we got the makings here. I think the Riddler used to play
saxophone.
Sax, yeah.
I can sing. Do like a rock band.
Mass J-Mart, like dueling banjos.
Yeah. Right, it's good.
I can sing in rock band.
I'll just hit the drumsticks together. Whole time.
All right, well, Riddler.
Again, Anthony thinks that the Dave Matthews Band is going to play in Bridgeport.
Hey, maybe.
Sure, why not bring him?
But, you know, baseball, I think we said kind of everything there is right now. It's the infancy of the season.
Trout's killing it.
Yeah, well.
Five home runs in four games.
Killing it for a team that's going to suck.
Hey.
Well, does suck. It is. Will continue sucking.
It's too bad. Like, I hate that he re-signed with the Angels. I just wish he went anywhere that's competitive.
He could have been a Philly.
Any player, you know.
Souls will die.
Really, though, I just wish he went to a team that can contend. Not like an automatic World Series bidder, but just contend. Because we're going to watch a guy that's on pace to be the greatest player to ever play do nothing. And it's kind of a bummer.
They'll make the playoffs one time. Once Pujols is done.
I said, if I'm the Angels owner, I would do anything in the world to get Theo Epstein to be my GM. Because he'll build a championship team.
And then they'll suck for a few years.
Whatever.
That's what they're doing right now. What's tuning the difference?
In. They're another disappointment of a team so far.
Who's that?
The Cubs. Their bullpen is atrocious. The pitching, the rotation's been atrocious. They have literally Javier Baez, not the only one hitting right now. They're a team lost in desperation.
Bracket break.
All right. Starting it off right.
This is not a new thing. You should do this all the time. So I made a custom bracket. I will make another one later. I like doing these. These are fun. So today's first bracket is most hated athletes.
Oh, boy. Here we go.
All right. So, Rebecca, pick a quadrant, 1 through 4. All right. So starting off, the 1 seed versus the 4 seed. Number 1, Roger Clemens versus the number 4 seed, Jay Cutler. So vote for the one you hate the most.
Jay Cutler.
That's bullshit.
I loved Roger Clemens.
Clemens all the way.
Roger Clemens. You can't hate
I'm not going to say Jay Cutler because he's not going to lose. So Roger Clemens.
That's a stupid way to play that.
Nah.
That is a very dumb way to play that.
So wait, hold on. Does the most hated move on or does the one with the least votes move on?
No, the most hated moves on because it's the most hated athlete.
Right. Stash goes Tim Tebow right off the bat.
Shut up, Stash. I don't even know you.
All right, and then the number 2 seed in that one, Rafi Torres, he was a hockey player. He was the Dennis Rodman of, hockey.
Did he wear a wedding dress?
No, but he was, the dirtiest player ever. He used to just, he used to, like grab people by like their skates. Like when he would get, he like go dive on the ice and grab their skates, so they'd fall on their face and like hit people in the chest with their with the stick and all that.
Who's
stuff.
Who's he going up against?
He's the 2 seed going up against the number 3 seed Barry Bonds.
Oh, Rafi.
Bonds. Fuck Barry Bonds.
You had no reason to hate him.
Fuck Barry Bonds. He cheated, Kyle.
So did Clemens.
Yes, you're right. Valid argument. You win this round.
it may not make the game more interesting, but steroids has made this show more interesting.
Whoever the hockey player was.
Okay.
3-3 nice, baby. Reese.
It's Russ.
Bonds.
Is Stoudemire saying Tebow should be on this list? Can we kick him out of our chat?
you stepped away for a second.
Yeah.
Actually, he's the defending champion of my self-made bracket, so I'm going to vote Tebow. Oh, okay.
Tebow's fantastic.
Moving on to the we'll go 4 on this one. All right, so the number 1 seed, Golden State Warriors.
Just all of them?
Everyone hates somebody on that team.
Draymond.
And then versus the number 4 seed, T.O.
Warriors.
T.O.'s a pretty hated dude.
I hated T.O. so much.
Get your popcorn ready.
T.O.
I'd love him for that thing.
And then
can't
in
hate
that same
that.
Division, the number 3 seed, Ron Artest, versus the number 2 seed, Alex Rodriguez.
Ron Artest.
Oh. Artest.
Oh, A-Rod.
I'm going Artest.
Artest.
I like A-Rod.
I'm obligated to like A-Rod.
He was once in a generation player.
All right, back to the ones. So the number 1 seed, LeBron James, versus the number 4 seed, Bryce Harper.
LeBron.
This is a tough one.
6 months ago, Kyle.
Yeah. I don't like LeBron.
You still would have taken Harper.
You still would have
LeBron.
Said Harper.
I also would have been on LeBron dick if you joined Philadelphia. So.
Oh, absolutely. You pushed for that for a while.
I just hope all these guys, like, I hope Melo signs with the Sixers. Like, all these guys that Jeff loves, like, Kyle's just like,
tough one. Because I don't hate either of these players.
Neither do I.
I'm going to go LeBron because
he's a douche of a Laker.
Yeah. Well, that's probably my answer.
That and, like, he just, like,
he quit.
It's not that he quit. It's just like a player like him, like, screams like the type of person he is, like, personality wise, off the court, screams like loyalty and dedication.
Yes.
But then, like, chased like the rings and like initially like from to Miami and then back to Cleveland when they started getting pieces, and then Cleveland started to suck. So he was like, I'll go to LA. I'm gonna, you know, it just, I don't know. So LeBron for me. So we got 2 LeBrons.
Matt? Harper.
Harper?
Matt? I said LeBron.
Doesn't matter, but you can pick.
Harper.
I was hoping to get a better reaction out of Kyle.
All right. The number 3 seed, Reggie Miller, versus the number 2 seed, Brad Marchand.
Hold on. Jeff loves Reggie Miller.
Brad Marchand.
Brad Marchand.
Reggie Miller.
Now, here's the thing. I love Brad Marchand, but he might be the most hated hockey player of all time.
He was the one licking faces, right?
Yep.
Reggie Miller.
I'm sorry, what?
He licked the guy's
face.
He
was like
to
licking
face. Him.
He did it a few times.
Yeah, he's done it a few times. He actually got suspended for licking somebody one time.
Oh, I heard about this. This is the guy the Bruins is
in? Yeah. He also threw like 2 raw chickens into the other team's locker room.
See, that's hilarious.
With a stink bomb on them.
That's even
more
funnier.
Hilarious. But like, but to us, yes. But to the team, hate him.
Yeah.
He's a hated person. I'm going Marchand. What'd you say, Kyle?
Marchand.
Mock?
Reggie Miller.
Marchand.
I like fighting him.
No, you like fighting him to get
Red
Chara.
Red Baron, did you vote?
I didn't, but Marchand, I mean,
he's a Bruin.
I hate all Boston sports.
And then the last
squadron
here, the number 2 seed, Floyd Money Mayweather, versus the number 3 seed, Ndamukong Suh.
Why is Antonio Brown on this?
Wow.
He might be.
Kyle, because he wasn't hated until like 3 weeks ago.
Why is Cortland Finnegan on
Mayweather.
This?
Mayweather.
Ndamukong Suh.
Mayweather.
Mayweather.
I hate Sue, but Mayweather is the worst.
Yeah, but he's only hated by like boxers. And Dominican Sue like steps on people's throat.
Listen,
he was fine this year though.
Yeah, because he wasn't the star. Yeah. All right, and then the number 4 seed, Vontaze Burfict, versus the number 1 seed, Tom Brady.
Perfect.
Brady.
I told you Anthony Tom Brady would be on the list.
Brady.
Perfect.
Perfect or Brady?
Brady.
Brady.
Wow. Well, he cheap shot Antonio Brown, so it's okay.
Perfect. Who'd you pick?
Perfect.
Oh, man. I'm picking Perfect.
There you go.
I don't hate Tom Brady at all.
Jumping back real quick, Stosh and Anthony both voted for Ron Artest. And Anthony also says Dennis Rodman was a dick.
Dennis Rodman was a dick, but I won't put him on here.
He was your dick. He was cheered to.
You own that. We're just going to round this whole thing out. All right, so we got LeBron James versus Brad Marchand. I'm going Marchand.
Yeah, Marchand.
Marchand.
You've got all the votes already, so.
LeBron.
The only reason that LeBron was the one seed is just because the amount of people that hate him versus the amount of people that hate Brad Marchand. But I feel like the hate for Marchand's great. All right, the number one seed, Roger Clemens, versus the number two seed, Rafi Torres.
Rafi Torres.
Rafi Torres was a hockey player that was very dirty. You were out when this happened. Like used to like take a skate off and throw it at people. Like he scaled
Happy Gilmore.
He made Happy Gilmore look like dirty.
Well, he took his skate off and tried to stab a guy.
But we didn't see that. He climbed out of a penalty box one time and dove like WWE style into the crowd to fight a fan.
That's pretty cool. See,
but that doesn't make me hate him. But him.
Well, it's not about who you necessarily hate. Torres. It's who you hate combined with hatred in general.
Clemens for me.
Kyle?
Is it because he threw a bat at Piazza?
It is partly. Mass is pouring himself a shot of beer. Shot of beer.
It's for the beer journal. So I can see what color it is.
Oh. I just look in the can and guess.
That's cheating. I pour it in my mouth and make people look at my mouth and tell me the color.
Right,
number four seed, Vontaze Burfict versus the number two seed, Floyd Money Mayweather.
Tom Brady?
Nope.
Perfect. Hold on.
Burfict.
Burfict or who?
Mayweather.
Burfict. Mayweather.
Burfict.
See, that's the thing. Like, I have no hate for Burfict just because Giants never played him.
But it's combined with hatred of
No, I know. But I think Mayweather is one of the most hated men in sports.
Yeah, Burfict.
He's been fined, Burfict has, for more than many players signed for.
Oh, yeah, I know that. All right, him and Sue.
Number one seed, Golden State Warriors versus the number two seed, Alex Rodriguez.
Warriors.
All right. And then so
Stashball weighing in, fuck Burfict.
One seed Golden State Warriors. He's a Browns fan. Number four seed Burfict. Burfict Warriors.
Perfect.
Perfect.
I'm going Warriors.
Ooh, swing vote. Swing vote mass.
Bless you. We get it.
Bless you.
All right, that wasn't an option. But that last sneeze did go all over the board.
I am going with.
All right, come
Warriors.
On, Warriors. Thank you. Ooh, I'm writing with my snot and marker. All right, number two, Brad Marchand versus the number two seed, Rafi Torres. Two hockey players made it. This is great.
Wow.
Marchand. All right, so Brad
Marchand
versus Warriors.
Warriors.
All right. And then,
so they win again.
And then the consolation prize here. Everyone answer as honestly as possible. We got the input. Reigning or newest champion Golden State Warriors versus reigning most hated athlete all time champion Tim Tebow. Who's the most hated?
Warriors.
Tebow.
Warriors.
Tebow.
Get out of here.
You know, Stash actually said something pretty funny. He goes, Jesus will save your life, but he won't teach you the playbook.
Laugh at Tebow, Mock. You want to.
Nope.
That's funny as hell.
Laugh at him. He's the Billy Ray Cyrus of football. Overrated and no one cares about him.
Billy Ray Cyrus.
He was a one-hit wonder.
That's not true. His tenure in baseball right now.
His tenure in baseball is just like Billy Ray Cyrus's rap career. No one cares.
He had a rap career?
He has a song out now.
Like it's a song out right now.
With like some like one of those like XX Tension guys. Yeah. Like one of those people that, you know, has tattoos on his face and doesn't know the whole alphabet, so he just uses the same letter four times. One of those types of guys. By the way, if you're one of those rap guys, at me now. Twitter beef.
Kyle's on Twitter right now.
One of my favorite
souls.
One of my favorite tweets of all time.
Mitchell Trubisky tweeting, "I love to kiss titties."
Yes, that is definitely up there. That's one of my favorite things.
Also, Dennis Smith Jr.'s tweet for my God-given talent is slang in this wood in my pants.
We're coming up on my favorite part of the NFL draft thing when they start pulling up old tweets.
Oh yep. Yeah.
They're like, hey, when he was 15,
that's going to start being a bigger thing.
I just want one of those ones where it's like, oh, when this guy was 13, he tweeted a dick pic. Here it is.
It's right here.
Blank Mayock. Ran a 4.34, benched 18 times, had a 42-inch vertical, 6-inch dick. Like, wow.
Pretty good.
You know, Mike Mayock is part of the Raiders now.
I know. He wants to see it. Looks like bliss is on, Kendall.
A moment of bliss.
No, she's in the ring.
Not for me.
You can watch it alone later.
Gross.
I'll give you my network login.
Gross.
Gross. Have you ever seen Alexa Bliss?
No, I haven't.
That's okay.
Well, have a gander.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of my favorite tweets of all time. Guy shut down Todd Gurley really hard. It was during Fisher's last year. Guy tweeted at him, you lost me my fantasy football championship. Todd Gurley actually took the bait and replied, pull up then. Guy responded to him, sure, I'll meet you in the end zone.
He also had another good Twitter beef with Tariq Cohen. That one was pretty funny, too. Tariq, yes. Cohen, who's bigger than me right now? And Gurley's like, literally everybody.
All right.
Sorry, Alexa Bliss is on the screen.
All right, well, we're going to step aside. We'll take an early break here. We'll regather. We have some hot take stuff to come on. We also got some NHL talk to come in probably in the third hour. The bracket, maybe.
Stay with us.
Oh, one. Alexa Bliss is beautiful.
And then, yeah, that's the word we use. Come with what? Yeah, we'll be back in about, I don't know, 6 minutes?
Whenever this match ends.
We'll be back soon. Turn off Facebook Live, Kendall.
And now, back to Getting Sports with Drunk on the PPRN Radio Network.
Welcome back to Getting Sports with Drunk. I'm your host, Cupcake the Riddler, and I'm joined by Poops. All of them.
Fuck you too, Riddler.
Yeah, I know. Real quick, what's everyone drinking? Red Dog.
Red Dog.
Red Doggin.
Not yet.
What? That was Face from Nick Jr.
That's Blue.
That's Blue's Clues.
Nope. You don't remember Face? Yeah, I don't know if you know this, but he was a blue dog. This is Red Dog.
You raise a fair point, I'm sorry. Clifford, somebody go get Clifford.
Push-ups.
Yeah, push-ups right now. As many as you can do.
Give me the private stock.
Okay.
Ooh.
Massey, liking him today. Give me it.
I'm liking you today. How do you feel about walking to Krauser's with me in about an hour?
Not great.
So, we're back here.
Bow,
bow. Awful.
So we were going to do some hot take stuff. I believe Mass had some.
Yeah.
Everybody else come up with some?
I did not. I got caught up at work today.
But you can't think of some off the top of your head as we go?
I'll try as we
go. We'll start with the one that's been cycling the net recently, which is Paul Pierce stating that he had a better career than Dwayne Wade. And then combating that with if he had the power, the star power as in Shaq and LeBron, like Wade had, that he would have easily 5 or 6 rings. So, not really a hot take, more of a discussion question, I guess.
Well, he technically had Shaq, so.
All right, yeah. Like, in the same way that, like, the Bills would have Tom Brady in 3 years.
That would be hilarious.
Really, Drew Bledsoe. Peter and Ricky both watching. Thank you for tuning in.
Hey. I'm surprised they get service where they are. So anyway, so, Souls, care to chime in on that?
Yeah. Paul Pierce is an asshole.
I think Paul Pierce is one of the most overrated NBA
players. I don't even
think
he meant it.
I don't know. He was pretty heated. He's, like, all about, like, thinking, like, he, like, argues about himself all the time.
Yeah.
I think he's very overrated. I mean, I thought he was a very clutch player. But so there was a stat line that went out yesterday, or, like, a thing to back it up. Dwayne Wade could play all 82 games next season and not score a single point and still have a better scoring average.
Wow.
I mean, I think Wade, when I think, I don't think Paul Pierce even cracks the top 5 best small forwards of all time, and Dwayne Wade arguably is the best shooting guard of all time.
Hey, shooting guards are important.
Especially the ones that pass.
Absolutely.
Get this guy a contract. Have you seen his tape?
Been trying.
I don't know. I mean, like, it's not like he never had a team around him. He had KG and Ray Allen and Rondo and Big Baby Davis.
Kendrick Perkins,
Eddie House. Like, they had a team. And yeah, they won a ring and they went to another. They went to 2 finals and they could have gone to more. I mean, I don't know. Like,
after he left the Celtics, he kind of became trash.
Yeah. Oh yeah. No, big time. He was terrible on the Clippers. Well, not the Clippers was actually probably his best of the post teams. He was not a good wizard.
He was an average net.
Yep.
That's really about it.
And he was only okay on the Clippers because what else did they really have going on? Chris Paul had left.
No, not yet.
But I mean, like, after Chris Paul left, Paul Pierce probably, did Paul Pierce retire when he left same year?
No.
Paul Pierce has only been retired for 2 seasons.
I don't know. I think it was a year before he left.
Paul Pierce has only been retired for 2 seasons.
Either way, he sucked.
What's the question?
No, we're not. Okay. Fact checker.
Well, I know when on our
trip. Listen, does Massey suck? See what it says. Get back to us.
On our trip to Philly, you know, you're reading off a bunch of stats, and you know, favored Wade heavily. You know, a lot of stats. You know, it's hard that for Pierce to come at me.
And it's not like Wade wasn't clutch either. Like, I mean, Wade had some pretty big buckets at some pretty key times, especially in the playoffs. I don't know. I can't. I think Wade is a top 50 player.
He's also a likable guy. Paul Pierce is not.
Yeah.
So I Googled that.
Yep.
Found out there's somebody with my name has a blog and wrote a book called Stop Chasing Carrots.
So you suck.
Hey, is this book on Amazon?
Want to buy it?
Why not?
All right.
Only if it's under $5.
It is free on Kindle if you have Kindle Unlimited, which
I do. No one owns a Kindle.
Yeah, you live in a log cabin, you can download that.
Yeah, I have a Nook. I have a Walkit in my pocket.
But yeah, I don't think Pierce can be regarded as better than Wade.
Paul Pierce isn't even a top 3 Celtic. I don't think he's even a top 5 Celtic, in my opinion. I don't think so. I don't know.
Well, it's tough. I mean, not to...
I think it goes Jason Tatum. He's only 21.
Not to defend Pierce, but it's tough to become and crack like that top 5 of a franchise that's been around as long as the Celtics have. But I agree with you.
But he's just not better than Wade.
No, I agree. I don't think he
is. He didn't win before. You know, the thing is, it's not like Wade had the big three, just like Paul Pierce had the big three. But the Wade and Shaq championship, that was Dwayne Wade, really, that carried them. I mean, Shaq, don't get me wrong, definitely helped. But outside of Wade and Shaq, where did the really, reliable scoring come from? I mean, they had Udonis, who was a glass eater and defensive prowess. Alonzo Mourning on the tail end of his career. Jason Williams on the tail end of his career. Gary Payton past the tail end of his career. I mean, I think they had James Posey then, too, didn't they? It's not like they just didn't have consistent scoring. They had just had a really good depth, and they had good bench scoring.
Quick interruption.
Paul's going to go nuts.
Please tell me that Pat Neshek just hit a home run.
No.
Nope.
Even Rose, better. Open to Bulls reunion.
Yeah.
Rose's agent. I don't know what Bulls are going to do at this particular time. If it's presented itself, we'd be open.
I got to go home. I gotta go home. There's a bottle of Jergens and a jersey in my closet, and I just need to go to
Stop pretending you don't travel with that jersey everywhere you go.
What?
Stop pretending you don't travel with that jersey everywhere you go.
I don't. Too afraid I'll get hurt. That'd be better than any.
Is that better than when Jared Allen signed with the Bears?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, because Jared Allen wasn't a Bear. It's just Jared Allen playing with the Bears meant I could like Jared Allen without being an asshole. That's really what that was all about. But, if Derrick Rose came back, I would be... If Derrick Rose signed any contract with the Chicago Bulls where he actually plays, not, a one-day contract, even if it was just a one-year deal, I would be happier than if the Bears won the Super Bowl next year. Wow. That would make me happier.
Wow.
You know...
It's true.
I can't buy that.
All right, you don't have to buy it.
I'm not saying it's not true, but...
Oh, shit. 2 minutes ago, D-Rose opened a Bulls reunion. Guys, I gotta get out of here. I gotta go home.
Welcome to the 20th.
It would make me happier.
What other takes you got for us?
Massey had some. He's probably got them by memory because he's watching the you know, between him and Kyle, we got baseball going on in this thing. This isn't a sports bar, guys.
Am I not allowed to watch sports?
No.
I'm getting sports with drunk?
I'm not talking. Watching sports with drunk.
That's our Tuesday night show.
The Thursday show is getting drunk with liquor.
I think towards the middle of the season, maybe even towards the end of the season, a little bit more, the Yankees are going to fall off. I don't think they end up winning the division, and I don't think if they make the playoffs, they make it past the first round. Their power comes from home runs and home runs only. Besides Frazier, they have no power to get base hits.
Now, to combat that, the team has been built the same the last 2 years and have made it past the first round of the playoffs. And they have a better pitching staff this season. So I disagree.
Do you think you can sustain that all season long? They had the ability to get
I got two words for you, Mark. Greg Bird.
He's not going to be on the team the whole season. No, I mean, the Yankees, they he improved. He probably will.
Nobody wants him.
They improved the pitching staff and the lineup even still. I mean, if Frazier stays
up. You don't
up,
know what's going to happen with Seve, though. That's already a downgrade to the pitching core.
Yes, but the rotation is still above average, I guess. I mean, they could still use another starter, but the guys that they have in the rotation aren't schmucks.
I would say with Severino gone, their pitching talent is the same as it was last year.
And they were a 100-win team last year.
I still don't think that they have the pieces to be able to get them through everything. But then Duhar gone, with Stanton gone as far as or for as long as he is.
But again, DJ LeMahieu is filling in for Andujar.
I do like LeMahieu. I will give
and
you that.
And LeMahieu's, he has, what, 2 gold gloves? I think it is. He's a great ball player.
Good, okay, good let's signing. Not forget his silver slugger. That guy fucking has 350.
No, I know. That's what I'm saying. He's a great ball player.
What's the other kid that I hate on that team, though? Anderson is his name? Is that who I'm thinking of?
Anderson. Nope.
No, hold on. I'll find out who I'm thinking of.
Nope, not him.
And, I mean, even Stanton, I mean, he's out now. He's not going to be gone the whole year. And I think we're going to see him DH a lot more this season than we did last year. And that'll help keep Clint Frazier up. I mean,
that's going to fucking kill him.
I don't know. We'll see as it happens, but I still think the Yankees are going to be a 100-win team this
that's
year.
That's who I'm thinking of.
Who?
Talkman. Mike Talkman.
I don't know who the fuck that
exactly.
is.
Exactly.
How can you hate a guy that no one knows?
Because he's
saying,
shit.
100-win team? No. Do I think they win 85-plus? Yeah.
I think they'll hover right around the same.
I don't think they make it past the first round.
I think they finish between 98 and 99 wins.
I don't know. I think the Orioles team got your number.
The Orioles always do, but they're going to win 40 games.
No, not always.
All against the Yankees.
It's just because they're the bad team now. When the Rays were the bad team, they had your number.
That's what I mean. Like, especially now, the Red Sox are weaker this year than they were last year.
Rays are a better team, though.
The Rays are better, but again, the Rays are always that team that doesn't do anything. They play spoiler, but they don't do anything.
They have the pitching to be good.
Yeah. But that's it. I mean, you still have to score runs.
They do. I'm telling you, they picked up Tommy Pham. They picked up. I mean, they still got Kevin.
God, Pham is there.
He's good. You got Kevin Kiermaier. You know, they need another first baseman because that guy sucks ass. But they have a decent squad. Avacio Garcia.
Anthony from the chat's on your side, Mark. I'd be curious to see if he has any points to combat Massey.
It's one of those things. I mean, even if. With Severino gone, the pitching staff takes a hit. I mean, they're scoring runs like crazy.
That can't last, though. Not at the rate that they're going.
Even if it's not at the rate, I mean, I think this would be the last two seasons, I think they've led the league in home runs. So, I mean, it's not like it was a fluke thing. They're a power-hitting team.
I will say, though, I do like Judge's adjustment.
Yeah.
He's got down on the strikeouts with his minor not lifting up his fucking leg so damn high.
Yeah.
Going for the home run ball every 5 seconds.
I guess what I would say to perhaps side with Mass, and this wasn't really addressed, but if injuries plague the Yankees all year, then there's no shot.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that could be said for every team. Not
exactly.
Team.
Right, right.
I mean, if everyone gets hurt, then.
But it's more notable this year for them rather than in years past.
Yeah. And that's what I mean. Like, Severino will be back at some point. I don't think they're going to rush him back because I don't think they'll need to. And even Stanton, I mean, it would be nice to have his bat in the lineup, but they don't need to rush him back.
It's too early for that.
Exactly. That's what I mean. Like,
you know, Sanchez will be out for at minimum a month this year.
I mean,
Sanchez hit a home run off a second baseman yesterday.
Sanchez is looking, again, it's still really early, but like we saw Sanchez play pretty bad baseball last year. After
he
playing
just
great baseball
so
the year
much.
Before. So, if he's a every other season guy, then hey, this is it.
Another AJ Burnett, baby.
But the Yankees lineup right now, I mean, again, it's early, but everyone seems to be relatively dialed in and playing good baseball. Of course, there'll be stretches where that doesn't happen, but...
I don't know. 100 wins is always tough.
Oh, yeah.
Like I don't think they'll reach 100.
I think they'll be right around there. I mean, 90, 5+. I think they'll be right around there. They have enough offensive firepower. They have enough depth. The rotation is still good. The bullpen is top notch. It's just a matter of going out and executing. Get
back to normal.
That's what I mean. It's just a matter of them going out and executing. The biggest thing that's going to kill the Yankees is when they lose the games you're not supposed to lose. When you lose to the Orioles.
And they do that quite often.
But they've done that for the last 80 years. I mean, that's just how they are. But that's what hurt them last year. I mean, the Red Sox were able to pull away with the division late in the season last year because we dropped two series to the Orioles late. And then in a four-game series with the Red Sox, we lost, I think, three of them. And that was it right at the end. But the Yankees, I still think, will be in the run for the division right till the end with the Red Sox once they straighten out and if the Rays hang on. But I think the Yankees are going to have a fine season.
Yeah. I have a quick hot take. It's for the whole table here. Mine is Souls will never find another beer he likes as much as Super Double Citra, Super Duper Citra, whatever it's called.
Yeah, you're right.
All right, hot take over.
I disagree, because they make a Super Duper Triple Citra.
Do they?
Yep.
Yeah.
Souls?
And it's got the green Power Ranger on the can, so you lose, Kendall.
And Reese Hoskins sweating it.
It's fermented in Harper's jock.
Jock jam.
What do you got, Mazzy?
That was it.
Oh.
You only had one?
For now.
All right.
The cat's out of the bag. Contributing right now?
Brown's a douchebag, yes or no?
Kyle, yes. Like,
I don't know. Who's going to defend Brown at this point?
Really?
Well, Raider fans will.
No, even them.
They will.
I'm sorry. I know we talked about it on the show, and like when Brown was going on and on about like the things with Ben, and I know I said there were some things that I was like, listen, he's going about it wrong, but I agree with some things. The whole thing with Juju is horrible. It's horrible. You got Smith-Schuster, who's become like one of the most liked guys in the league, and for no reason at all, Brown's like taking shots at him.
No, he literally said it's because he won the MVP of the team.
But that's what I mean. It's for no reason,
bro.
It's not like he voted himself to team. All right, he may have voted for himself, but it's not like he elevated himself to that position. His teammates voted him.
He was a better player than him last
year. But even still, I mean, to then try and knock him down. You know, you fumbled in this game. That's horrible.
Yeah, like it happened. Like we all know as a
you
fan.
Sat out because your ego got bruised. Fuck off.
Like we know that he fumbled in the thing, but you know what? You saw that he cared about it, and he's gonna try to make his fix his mistakes.
The other thing that made me kind of lose it with Brown is he posted. I don't know if you guys saw this. He posted like a direct message that Juju sent him on like Instagram from like 3 or 4 years ago when Juju was in college, saying like, you know, hey man, I love watching you. Do you have anything that can like help me improve?
If anything else, that proved his point that Juju's a good, respectful kid.
And Brown like screeched and it's just he's a child. I mean, we were talking about this at your house before, Kendall. If he doesn't put up like 1,800 receiving yards this year, he'll never be taken seriously again.
No,
I don't think it's put up 1,800.
I'm just like if he doesn't go out and like ball out this year,
and he won't.
Well, he could, Kyle. He's still good. He's still good.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying like the Raiders don't have. They could triple team all they want. Raiders have no offensive line. Dakar's still gonna be hit every other fucking snap.
Yeah,
they have a very expensive left tackle.
And like he wasn't even that fucking great.
Yeah,
Kyle, he had a good year.
Well, you know what's interesting?
He had a good year. The Raiders like to sign these guys that had a good year.
Just a
not Brown, not Brown.
I'm saying Brown was good last year. Like he's still a great receiver. He's just an asshole.
Just real quick to double back a second, and maybe you Mock or Matt can look it up. I saw a thing today, and it was something about Browns versus Juju's fumbles per amount of receptions. Juju had like a fumble every 111 receptions, where Brown is every 58 receptions.
Yeah,
something like that.
Something
so I just thought
stupid.
That was interesting.
Juju's was a lot higher than that.
No, I saw that. It
you
wasn't,
saw that too. Whatever
yeah,
it was,
it wasn't that. It was. So, It's a bad stat to look at. It wasn't off of receptions. It was off of carries.
Of carries. Okay. I saw the numbers.
Not touches, which is a bad thing to go off of because Brown was a return man for a long time.
Another thing.
Which, yes, it's still ball security, but like Brown
it's
is
different.
No longer a return man. It's like you can't judge OBJ.
Isn't Juju returning it now?
No.
No, I don't
forgot
think so.
Who said it. Somebody literally said today, I can't wait to fucking hit Brown.
Yeah, somebody, oh, it was the safety was for the Cowboys or for the Texans. From the Texans, yeah.
Justin Reed. Yeah. I can't wait to smack this guy.
No, it was whatever that Hall kid is.
Who's your nose tackle?
Hayward?
Tim Hayward?
He's not the
nose
tackle.
It's right here. Hold on.
Do the Steelers play the Raiders this year?
No, they do not.
Somebody, I forget who it was. Somebody on the Steelers said.
Vince Williams, Steelers linebacker. Vince Williams.
Was it him that said it?
I think so.
What did he say?
Was it about not addressing his relationships on social? No.
It was somebody, I think it was a defensive tackle or something like that. But somebody said, like, a reporter asked him, what do you think about this stuff between Juju and Brown today? And he was like, man, all this beef, I'm going vegan. And I was just like, that's good.
It was probably Jonathan Hargrove.
When,
yeah.
Me and Kyle were talking about it today. Like, I know Juju's, like, responded. And he hasn't said anything bad and whatever.
No, he's like, I looked up
to
him.
This is
the same
way to saying to getting too entwined.
But if I'm Mike Tomlin, I tell him, listen, ignore it.
It's done.
It's
over.
It's got to be done. No distract. Like,
beat him with the stats.
Tomlin's got to get back to that no nonsense code. Like, he's got to get the locker room back in check.
He kind of already did because Morgan Burnett was complaining.
I think that they're willing to let Juju have this little, because as long as he doesn't say anything stupid.
That's what I mean. He hasn't gone crazy. But
this is like a hurt thing. It's like imagine like this happening. Like imagine you were a baseball prospect coming up, and this happens between you and Derek Jeter. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I would ask to be traded with Derek Jeter, but I see what you're saying.
Yeah. To the Red Sox.
Yeah, be like, we're a package deal.
To the Red Sox.
Souls, you were right.
I'd probably still go with Jeter.
Do you go with him to the Red Sox, Reed. And then and the Yankees sign Tebow?
Yeah, I'd still rather be with Jeter.
And Zach Ryder.
Oh, no.
The thing about this is that it was just like...
And the Red Sox signed Kevin Nash.
I retire.
All Juju really said was, hey, you know, all I really did was look up to you.
Oh, absolutely.
And, like, you're just going to kind of, like, come out at me?
But that's what I mean. Juju didn't say anything bad. It's not like he took, like, a vindictive road. Like, he was fine. But, again, if I'm Tomlin or even, like, Steelers front, be like, listen, leave it. Do it on the field. Like, don't even acknowledge it. We gotta stop this. Because the last two seasons for Steelers have been kind of...
It's been
days of our Steelers.
But even if it's the two guys that are gone, like, it's still been a problem in the locker room for two seasons. And Tomlin's got to shut it down.
I would like to take a second.
What's up, Dane? Dane tuned in.
Hey, Dane.
I know. I stopped for you. What's up, and acknowledge the fact that Le'Veon Bell came out and said today he doesn't like to get involved in his social media kind of shit and, you know, tweet out personal responses. But he took a snapshot of a message that James Conner sent him and said, this is what being teammates is all about. And it was just a really touching message. Bell stood out all offseason, kept his mouth shut.
Not really, though. Because he was, like, commenting on other teams' things, like, talking about playing with other teams and...
But he's allowed to do that. You know the Steelers aren't going to do anything. He's not bad-talking teammates.
He wasn't there.
Who, Bell?
Yeah. He wasn't there.
He wasn't part of the team.
Yeah.
And the Steelers Everybody knew that. Showed up for day one of training for today for the Jets. He was friends with all his teammates. He never talked bad about anybody. I understand what he did in holding out. It didn't work out for him in the end. He didn't get as much money as he thought he was going to.
It did work out for him. That's the thing. It did work out for him. It worked out for him.
He lost out on money, but
yes.
It wasn't about just money. Really, if you really sit down and think about it, he wanted the stupidly large contract. I mean, he wanted them to just be willing to be like, all right, Gurley got, what, 16 mils? Is that what Gurley got?
Something
all right,
like
we'll
that.
Give you 20. Like, he was hoping for something like that, because that's what I think it would have cost him to want to stay with the Steelers. Now, I'm not bashing the Steelers at all. Bell, I just don't think Bell wanted to be a Steeler unless he was getting paid the most amount of money any running back was ever getting paid.
Right. Because if he really wanted to be a Steeler,
once they
offer stayed.
Him, like, hey, we're going to give you a great contract, but it's not going to be what Gurley's making, he's like, I'm going to hold out. See if you give me more. If you don't, you don't. This is my statement. I don't want to be a Steeler.
That's fair.
I think it goes beyond just the money. Because, really, I mean, think about it. If it was just about the money, he could have negotiated more money. He could have easily negotiated more money out of the Jets. Very easily.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Or he could have gone and signed a lesser time frame deal for more money for the Colts. Because I read a report that the Colts would have been willing to give him more money, but they would have wanted it over less years because of injury reasons. So like, they would have given him maybe 15.8 mil, but it would have been over 2 years.
But the thing is, like what Matt was saying, is that Bell never went after the teammates. He went after the front office.
And even then, he didn't even really do that.
Like Bell was never a bad teammate.
The point I'm making is, even while he was sitting out, he was commenting and posting things on other teams' pages.
But he was also rooting for the younger guys.
But, hold on. So, him commenting, the one I remember off the top of my head was for the Colts, talking about playing with the Colts. It may not have been a direct shot at any teammates, but I remember Roethlisberger being upset because he was asked about it in interviews. Tomlin was... So, he's not calling out teammates, but it was still a distraction on social media. That's the point I'm making.
He's not a part of the team.
This is by far the absolute beginning of all of this.
Yes.
This is going to continue forever with players because it's our generation of people. Like, we may not be like that, but maybe we would be if we had those platforms. We don't have those platforms. Maybe we would be like that if we did. Maybe we would be like that if we were when we were 23, someone handed us $5 million a year. $5 million a year makes you do a lot of stupid shit. I do a lot of stupid shit with $500. I mean, it's
$5.
Like, yeah, really. I mean, no, I just go to Taco Bell. But I mean, it's
exactly.
Stupid. Yeah, colon sizers. But I mean, but it's just like you don't know how people don't know. Like everyone like says like, oh, like I say to myself all the time, like if I was a star athlete for the Chicago Bears, like the best linebacker that's ever played football, I would take a 5-year deal for $10 million a year. It's more than enough money for me, and it gives gives my organization plenty of opportunity to go out and sign other players. But is it true? Is that true? Do I know that? No, because I've never been offered $10 million. No one's ever come to me like, I'll give you $10 million to do this. Like, it's not been a real thing for me. Like, someone's like, I'll give you $10 million for this, but for the same exact thing you're about to do, you could also get $25 million. Well, okay, I want the 25. That sounds cool. You know what I'm saying? And our generation is very short attention span. And Brown may be, what, 30?
31.
But even though he... But 31, like, oh, like 31, like, compared to Juju. But, like, compared to us, that's 5 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The difference between Juju and Brown is 10 years. And we're right in the middle of that. That's our generation of people. And overall, our generation sucks ass.
Yeah.
And it's very short attention span. It's very social media driven. It's very, what do people think about me? And this is just... Brown and Bell doing this is we're just going to continue to see it. The reason it was so blown up and taken out of proportion, it was because it was two star players on the same team.
Yeah.
If this was Bell and Julio Jones, it would not be as big of a deal. It's only because it was Bell and Brown.
Yeah.
It would have been this big if it was the same thing on any other team. If next year it's Elliott and Cooper. If last year it was Barkley and Beckham.
That'd be really cool if it was Elliott and Cooper.
But if it was, you know, if it was Barkley and Beckham last year, you know, or...
Days of our Cowboys.
Just because it's this two star players on the same team. A team that's been winning for a long time. And then to top all of it off, didn't make the postseason.
Yeah.
It just exemplifies it so much more.
Yeah. I think it's actually very well said. That was very, very articulate. A good way to sum it up.
Here, I'll finish it up for you. Fuck Antonio Brown. Done.
Yeah, I think a lot of... People on our, we feel that way.
It's too bad because it happens so fast.
Right.
It happens so fast.
And as a fan, you know, I've said this many times, I'm very disappointed because, you know, until recently, you know, I really liked Antonio Brown and Le'Veon Bell. And it's just, I thought that would have been the Steelers team for, you know, until it fell apart.
Hey,
you know,
Boswell's still there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's funny, with all this stuff with Brown and Bell happening, nobody's talking about the drama going on with Aaron Rodgers and his former teammates like Greg Jennings. And
because, you know what, I don't think anyone's surprised by that. I don't think anyone's surprised that Aaron Rodgers is a head case.
Well, it's the head case stuff is coming out because of the bashing of McCarthy.
Yeah.
Because McCarthy came out on some NFL show and said that, you know, contrary to popular belief, he was actually very surprised about his firing after the Cardinals game. He thought that he would have been given the rest of the year. He's like, I wouldn't have been surprised if I was fired by the end of it, but he goes, I was very taken back when I got called into the office. I was not expecting to lose my job.
He got fired midseason?
He got fired after they lost to the Cardinals at home in week
14? 10.
I mean, anybody would get fired after.
It was later than that. It was more towards the end of the season.
Anybody would have gotten fired after those Cardinals.
It was somewhere between like 11 and 12, maybe. Somewhere over.
I think it was a little later. I think it was like 13, 14. I don't know when they played the Cardinals. We have to look it up. But I think it was later towards the end of the season. Because that was kind of like the cementing of their, like, no postseason.
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, not technically, but you know what I mean. But, like, that all happened, and then, yeah, it's... No, Rodgers is a control freak.
That's what I mean. Like, I don't think that's surprising anyone that all this is coming out, and they're like, well, no. We knew that.
And,
you know?
Yeah, it is what it is. All right. I got a hot take. Two of the four top four seeds in the Eastern Conference for the NBA... Two of those four teams will be eliminated in the first round.
Yeah.
Wow.
No.
Yeah.
All right. any other insight we got going on here? So let's do it based off of the seedings as of right now. Now the 7 and 8 seed can still change, but we'll do it based off of the seeding as of this exact moment in time. The top four teams are going to be Milwaukee, Toronto, Philadelphia, and Boston. That's pretty much locked in. Outside of that, though, your bottom four seeds are Indiana at the 5, Brooklyn at the 6, Orlando at the 7, which last week Orlando was out of the playoffs, and they've locked in the playoff spot. And then the 8th seed right now is Detroit by a game, and then Charlotte and Miami are a game out. So we'll just call it Detroit. Now, the reason I say that, I think Brooklyn can give any one of those four teams a strong 7-game series where it comes down to whoever has the ball last. I think Brooklyn is playing very well as a team. I think Brooklyn has a lot of underdog-type players that even, you know, that are still playing the underdog role. Like, people have noticed how good they've been as a unit, but at the end of the day, now the postseason's coming around, people are like, okay, like, they had a great season, but they're still a 6 seed, and it just adds that fuel to the fire. And they are led by a very improved D'Angelo Russell. They're very good defensively. I could see them giving any one of those four teams fits in 7 games. I also don't trust Boston enough to beat Indiana. I think I wouldn't be surprised if either team walked out with a victory. And to go beyond that, with Orlando being 1.5 up on Detroit, Orlando's locked the 7 seed up. So Detroit would have to be the 8 seed. I think it would only be Detroit. I wouldn't give it to Charlotte or Miami if they squeak in. But I think Detroit can be physical with Giannis. I think Detroit can surprise the Bucks. I'm not going to say that they're going to beat them, but I could see it happening. The only one as of right now, I can't see Orlando beating Toronto. That's the one I guaranteeingly can't see. But, like, who knows? I mean, think about it. If Orlando wins their last game and Brooklyn loses, Orlando now becomes the 6 seed. I don't think Orlando can beat the Philly 76ers either, but I definitely think Brooklyn can beat Toronto. I think Brooklyn could beat Toronto, no problem. Not no problem, but I think that that's the most favorable matchup that they can get between facing either the Philly 76ers or the Toronto Raptors. But it's one of those things where it's like, I hate the cop-out answer. You hear it a lot in sports analytics, but I won't be surprised if it's the top four seeds that go on, but I wouldn't be surprised. The only one I'd be surprised at is Orlando beating somebody. I just think Orlando got enough of a hot streak to bump him up to the 7 seed right here, but I don't think it's enough momentum to carry him through a series. But
yeah,
Detroit plays good basketball and they're physical.
Do you think that's enough that they'd be able to beat them through a 7-game series? You don't think that they would be able to...
Orlando, the only team Orlando could beat... The only team Orlando could
beat... No, I was talking about Detroit playing against Milwaukee. Weren't you just talking about that? Did I just miss that?
What about momentum?
No. You were talking about Detroit being physical against Giannis.
So that's a shot.
Antler combo.
Antetokounmpo! All
right, that's a shot from Mark.
Ah, I like saying it like that.
Yeah, but it's still a shot because it's antler combo on this show.
The
sign's right over there. I'm just saying...
Do you think that
it's
Detroit...
It's a hot take. It's meant for discussion.
Right, and I'm sorry, Matthew.
Discussing with you, do you think that that's something that Milwaukee would not be able to compensate for over 7 games? You don't think that they would be able to game plan against Detroit if they were being a little bit too physical with a combo during that game to be able to get a game plan together to...
If Detroit as a whole unit from starting five all the way to the 12th man decide to play physical basketball with everybody on the Bucks, no, the Bucks cannot out... I don't think the Bucks can out physical the Detroit Pistons. They can outplay them. That's for sure. But they can't... I don't think they can out physical. The Bucks outside of Giannis are not a physical team.
No.
Outside of Giannis and Brooke. Brooke Lopez can be a very physical person when he wants to be. But Chris Middleton's not a physical player. Mirotic's not a physical player. They're not, I don't think they're a physical team. I think that if Detroit can slow them down and play physical half-court basketball, they have a shot. I think they do. I would be surprised if Detroit beat them. That one I would be surprised. But I wouldn't be surprised if Brooklyn beat Toronto. And I wouldn't be surprised if Brooklyn beat Philly. I don't think it'll happen, but I wouldn't be surprised.
Who's your favorite going into the finals then? Or not to the
into
finals.
Into the Eastern Conference? Players?
Yeah.
Milwaukee.
Okay. I think Toronto.
I don't think Toronto has what it takes to get to the finals. I don't think Toronto will make it out of the East. I don't think Toronto can get through Milwaukee, and I don't think Toronto can get through Philadelphia.
If Detroit ends up playing...
Because in order for Toronto... In hindsight, if you really break it down, in order for Toronto to get to the finals, they have to beat Philadelphia in a best of seven. With, yes, they have home court advantage. Then they have to beat Milwaukee in a best of seven on the road.
If Detroit ends up going with your game plan of being physical with the Bucks, do you think that lays the groundwork for another team like, say, the Raptors to be able to go out and play the exact same game plan against them to be able to get past them?
What do you think if they play physical and then lose in seven?
Yeah, because
I think Detroit
may not be as good of a team as the Raptors.
I just think the only two teams in the Eastern Conference that have what it takes to play a physical, slow paced game for seven straight games in the Eastern Conference are Detroit and Philadelphia.
Okay,
because Philadelphia has lockdown perimeter defense and Jimmy Butler, all around great defense in Ben Simmons, and then lockdown interior defense with Joel Embiid. They also have good defensive players that come off the bench in Boban and that other big nose center there. What's his name, Kyle?
Bolden.
He's good defensively. McConnell's scrappy. He'll do whatever it takes to make sure that the other team doesn't score. The only weak link on that team defensively is J.J. Redick. Plays no defense. And Tobias Harris is not known for defense. He's got length. He's got speed. So he can catch you off guard and get the steal if he catches you napping. But he, like, Tobias Harris is not going to, like, lock up Kawhi. Like, that's not going to happen. But they don't need him to because they have two lockdown defenders and two good shot blockers if they get past them. But so, in my opinion, those are the only two teams that have what it takes to be physical with the Bucks for a seven-game series.
Hey, Uncle Bob, real quick. Thanks for listening. I agree a lot, Riddler, and I agree with you said about the Nets. I think kind of having a good shot to kind of go toe-to-toe with a lot of teams, you know, in the Eastern Conference.
The Nets just play good team basketball. That's what it really is. I mean, like, we've heard a lot about D'Lo, like, having a very much improved season, but is D'Angelo Russell even averaging more than 22 points a game, Kyle? I don't think he is. I think he's averaging, like, 21 or something, like 20, 21. Like, so it's insane. Like, he's having an improved season, and he's had some big games in terms of scoring, but at the end of the day, he's averaging, even if it is 22, 23 points, that's not a lot for a star of a team. And in order for them to, you know, I don't care what anybody says. If the East is weak or whatever, like, it's still competitive.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It doesn't matter if the teams overall in the East are inferior to those in the West. You're still playing the majority of your games against teams at a similar caliber and difficulty, which is going to give you hot streaks and momentum and team unity and things like that. Yeah, if they end up making it all the way through, are they going to beat the fucking Warriors? No, they're not. But I think they play good team unity. Yeah,
it still makes good for competitive basketball. I don't know what Rita was doing. Probably something Seth Rollins related.
Close.
Roman Reigns,
yeah.
Dean Ambrose.
Yeah.
The clock's ticking on him.
Yeah.
And also on Roman Reigns, yeah. But for, like, life purposes.
Well, I will say, perhaps to combat Riddler, and obviously you and Souls are more of authority on this than I am, I just feel like looking at the top four, the Bucks, Raptors, Sixers, the Celtics, for me, are clearly the weakest of the four, you know, record showing it, but I just feel like the way they play, they have the biggest chance to have to lose to a bottom four team. And that's just how I feel. I'm biased because I'm a big hater of the Celtics. But I just feel like, you know, this year versus last year, it's not the team that they thought it was going to be.
Indiana's one of those teams, like, they lost Oladipo, but they still play, like, a very gritty type of game.
For Indiana to finish the season out in a 5 seed, that speaks wonders to that team. Indiana could have finished this season at the 9 seed, and nobody would have blamed them. Would have blamed them at all. They would have just chalked it up to, you lost Oladipo, hard. But they lost Oladipo before that All-Star game, right,
All-Star break?
Was it before the All-Star break?
Yeah, like a couple weeks.
Wow.
Yeah, I think they lost him in like January.
But do you think that's a fluke for next year for them? Like, do you think they'll actually be...
What?
Nothing. Continue on.
What do you mean? I think it's a fluke that they lost Oladipo?
Hold on. Continue on. I'll gather my thoughts in a second.
No, we need to gather this now because I'm really confused. That they're winning without Oladipo? Is it a fluke?
Yes. Do you think that...
No.
The team...
Because they haven't had him since January.
Do you think that the team would survive next year should they lose Oladipo again?
Yeah.
Okay.
But this season kind of proves
because it's
that
not like they lost them 3 weeks ago and they just won the majority of the game.
They just finished out the momentum. Yeah, they've been playing all year. Fearless leader came
in. Good job. All right, so I got another hot take for you. The NFC North will own both wild card spots in the NFC this upcoming season.
Disagree.
Mass, care to elaborate?
You gotta elaborate, guys. You can't disagree.
I think that the Seahawks will end up taking a wild card spot this year, number one. What are we talking about again?
Paul, Nietzsche just got to save.
Oh.
Good.
Yes.
Yeah, I started him, though, but he got to
sorry.
I started him.
Sorry. Yeah. Panthers will take the second wild card spot this year. Panthers are a very every other year team.
Yeah, well, this is the other year.
Last year was their other year. They missed
this one's also another year.
Riddler, I'm going to disagree with you. I think, you know, the Bears have made great strides, and I think it's their division to win again. Vikings, I don't see, you know, duplicating anything, any success they may have had in the past 2 years.
And I disagree with you on that.
Okay, well, we'll jump back to that in a second. Lions are going nowhere fast, and Packers, I don't even know what to say about that team right now.
I actually disagree with you. I think the Lions are going to be a contender for the North.
No, I disagree with that 100%. But the Lions are terrible. So the Packers, though, the Packers went out. They broke the mold of – they did what the Bears did. They were a step late to what the Bears did, and something the Steelers have never done, and I think will be coming in their future – After Ben exits, and they kind of like, because you think about it right now, I mean, yes, they have people to draft, but after Ben exits, outside of Juju and their offensive line, they don't really have any other star players. And I think the Steelers will be the next team to do it, because outside of this, the Bears, the Steelers, and the Packers are the only three teams that throughout their entire history of their franchises, very storied, long franchises, have not been spenders in free agency. The Bears broke that mold last season. Last offseason, they went out and they got Burton, they got Robinson, they got Miller. They've been drafting correctly. They went out and traded for Mac. Now this year, the Packers decided that they were going to do that. Outside of Adams and Rodgers, they don't have anything. I mean, they've got Jimmy Graham, but
that's
still yet to be seen as an impactful player for that team. But they went out and they paid to have a good defense. That's what they did. They paid for a good defense. Well, pieces for a good defense. And now they've got loaded draft picks to help improve that.
Two first-rounders.
And defense. Two first-rounders, four in the first 75 picks. That's four players make an impact immediately week one. So I think the Packers could very easily cement themselves back into a playoff hunt, no problem.
I don't know that I believe in LaFleur to guide them there, though.
Doesn't matter. I know
he doesn't need to guide them there. Aaron Rodgers will guide them there.
He said that, and I immediately thought of Dodgeball.
Peter LaFleur?
Yeah.
I watched that movie last night.
I agree with Paul. Even though Aaron Rodgers has all this backfire at him right now, he's still Aaron Rodgers.
Yeah. Nobody knows that better than me. You know what I'm saying? Nobody knows it, but look at week one last year, second half of the game. And then on the flip side of it, the Vikings, I don't care what anybody says. Kirk Cousins did not have a terrible year last year.
No, he did not.
And he had a bad offensive line. And the defense didn't play up to standard. The defense might have been a top 10 defense, but you expect that Vikings defense now to be a number one defense. The Vikings, the Ravens, the Bears. Those are three teams that if they finish anything outside of top three in defense, it's a bad year for their defense.
Yes.
This coming year. So I think those three teams. Now, I think the only team this year that seriously right now on paper has the chance to upset those three teams, the Bears, the Packers, and the Vikings, wrapping up the North and the two wildcard spots, is the Atlanta Falcons.
I agree.
I don't give a shit about the Seahawks. The Seahawks were in it because the Falcons lost everybody.
Yes.
You got to keep in mind who's coming back to play defense for them. We're talking top 10 safety, top 20 cornerback, top 10 inside pass rusher. We're also talking about Matt Ryan, who is an MVP caliber quarterback, who has Julio Jones, who they showcase what Calvin Ridley can do. They're going to have a healthy Devontae Freeman. The biggest question for them is, what are they going to do now that they don't have the 1-2 punch of the back receiving backs? The Atlanta Falcons, for me, is the only team on paper right now, even before the draft, that can disrupt this NFC North clinching of the two wildcard spots.
You don't think that the Eagles have a chance to do that?
I don't think they have as much of a chance as the Packers.
And I think the Eagles win the division next year.
You think what?
I think the Eagles are better than the Falcons.
I think we see a similar...
Cowboys, I'm sorry.
I think we see a similar thing in that division that we saw this year. I think we see... I think it's a similar thing that we see almost every year in the NFC East, and it's just that none of the four teams put together a 13-3 record. They all put together, like...
9-6.
Yeah, 10-6 to 8-8. Like, so it's whoever kind of, like, gets hot in the last three games of the season.
Although, as much as I hate it, I think the Cowboys have the potential this year to do that 13-3 type thing. The defense last year was good.
I don't think they do. And the only... I think they have a very strong case to win the division. I think their case to win the division is stronger than the Eagles. And my biggest reasoning for that is just that
Wentz is going
to
get hurt.
Give me a reason to think Carson Wentz is playing 16 games.
Exactly.
And that might be a cop out, but whatever. But the Cowboys are
going to have
to do what they did last year against the Rams,
yeah,
the Saints, the Bears. And then I don't know what division what do the Giants play this year? Do you know what division they play?
The West. Or no, we played the West last year.
The
South. North. Is it the North?
I think the North and the South.
Oh,
yeah, because you said Giants.
You know what? We play the North.
So you have to play the Packers and the Vikings, yeah, whether home or away, the Cowboys.
And the Lions is not a gimme game either.
Right, and the Lions are not a gimme game. Patricia knows what to do. And then I don't know who they play in the AFC.
AFC West.
Yeah, it's the AFC.
Because next year they play the North.
So they play the Chiefs. The Broncos aren't a gimme game.
Oh, no, it can't be the AFC West.
It's in the East. They play the North.
It's the AFC East.
They play the North.
And you play the Patriots.
Yes.
Okay, so you're talking about the Cowboys having to go up against the Saints, the Bears, and the Rams for their seeding games. Then they also have to play the Eagles twice. They have to play the Giants twice, which is no gimme games in divisions. And they play the Redskins twice, which also is not a gimme game. No division game is a guaranteed home run. And
the Cardinals are a guaranteed home
run. No, it's not, though. But that's just it. It's not.
The Cardinals, to me, were kind of an underrated team last year defensively.
They were very
defensively, sure.
And then they have to go around. Then the Cowboys have to go.
Their offense played like JV.
They have to play the Patriots, the Jets, and the Dolphins. Or the Bills. Fuck the Dolphins. They'll be the Dolphins. But, I mean, that's not a gimme game, but it's a gimme game. But the Bills have a top-tier defense.
Are you still mad about that?
No. They have... I was never mad about the Dolphins game. That was Nagy's fault that they lost that game. But they have to play the Bills, they have to play the Jets, and they have to play the Patriots. And at least one of them is on the road. At least one, maybe two. I don't know who they play at home, who they play away. But at least
honestly,
one of them...
Honestly, the Cowboys have one very tough schedule.
Yeah, they have a very tough schedule.
And that's why I don't think they win.
I'm not saying that I don't think they win, but I think they still have the best odds as of right now to win the division. But
I guess that's the point I was trying to make. I mean, I think the Cowboys have the best all around roster in the division right now. I think Dak does enough to not lose you games. He's not a blow you away guy, but he won't lose the game. Amari Cooper, if he carries over, he's going to be a stud this year. I think Randall Cobb was a decent pickup. He's not what he was, but I think he can be good for that team. And I think keeping DeMarcus Lawrence was huge. Well,
Randall Cobb to me just is a more explosive Cole Beasley.
That's what I mean. Like he's just he'll just be a, you know, an average guy at this point in his career.
All right. So this one, this might be a little bit more geared to, but I'd like to. So, hot take on this one: the Tampa Bay Lightning don't make the Stanley Cup playoffs.
Agree.
I
say that.
Keep in mind too, this is a team that just matched the NHL record for most wins in the regular season with 62 wins. That's a lot.
What's up, Eric?
And I say that.
Handsome.
And I say that because the East is a bunch of proven winners, and the Lightning have never. Besides well, that one year,
if you want an example of how strong the East is, the Montreal Canadiens were the 16th best team in the NHL in terms of record, and they missed the playoffs.
Go Whalers!
The Hurricanes made the playoffs.
I know. After they left Hartford,
no, they made the playoffs this year. They won the Stanley Cup.
I'm saying after they left Hartford,
and I think I know the Capitals won last year. They're back in it. The Penguins, you can never count them out.
I hate them.
Yeah, but you can never count them out.
I hate them.
You can never count out the Bruins. You have a bunch of teams that have historically won in the last few years to play with the Lightning.
No, it's not.
The Lightning is great offensively, but if that switch is over, they're in some deep trouble. I don't know if you heard me, Paul, but...
The championship game is going on right now in NCAA. Masses and I are arguing. Because there's 7 minutes. It's the championship game, right, tonight?
Yeah.
Yeah. There's 7 minutes left in the first half, and Virginia's up 19-16. So he's telling
me. It's such a low scoring game.
But it's not. That's on pace to be like a 60-55 game. That's not low scoring.
That's how
college basketball is.
Virginia. No, it's not true.
But I mean, what I mean is in college basketball, you don't see 150-41.
No, 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 no.
That's what I mean.
But for a championship game, a 60-55 score, that's not uncommon.
Virginia's the best defensive team in the nation. That's a known fact.
So the last three games, 79-62, 71-65, and 77-74.
Yeah.
Okay, so 60 points. We're talking 15 points.
Virginia's the best.
It's not like you're making it seem like the game's going to finish off 30-18.
It might.
No.
I'll make you a deal. If no team, if both teams don't score over 55 points, I'll drink 10 shots of private stock over the next three.
Texas Tech is going to win anyways.
What's is there any gay hockey players?
I don't know. I'm
sure there is. So
what's my bet
Sidney Crosby.
So, real quick, well, yeah. So we talk about the Canadiens, but I already had this lined up, but then Mass decided to be a basketball guru for 5 seconds.
Fuck yourself.
Well, real quick, on the subject, Ridley, you and I were talking about, they were requesting to change seating, correct?
Yeah. We'll talk about that next.
And you also got hour. Columbus, who's a very...
Here we go. All right. So you got... Sorry, Kyle. I'm interrupt. You got Tampa Bay going up against the second wildcard team. So it's Tampa Bay, Columbus Blue Jackets, Bruins, Maple Leafs, Capitals, Hurricanes, Islanders, Penguins. And then in the West, it's Flames, Avalanche, San Jose, Vegas, Nashville, Dallas, Winnipeg, Blues.
There's got to be a gay guy on the Flames.
So in order for Tampa Proud. Has to beat Tampa would have to go through. Now they have home ice advantage throughout the whole Stanley Cup, even if they make it to the finals. But they have to go through Columbus, then they have to go through the winner of the Bruins and the Maple Leafs, and then they have to go through whoever comes out of Capitals, Penguins, Islanders, Hurricanes.
And I think that they're facing all these good offenses, and I think they could all score with them. And I don't know if they're as strong defensively as any of these teams.
I don't think they're gonna have a problem with the Blue Jackets. The problem is if the Maple Leafs lose to the Bruins, if it goes like this, if it ends up going Capitals, if the winners end up going Lightning, Bruins, Capitals, Penguins, they're going to be going. The three of the four teams in there have shown over the years they have what it takes to get hot for one game.
Yeah,
in the postseason, and the Lightning, they made it to the Stanley Cup playoffs, but then they lost in six. So, and since then they've been better since they lost to the Blackhawks.
Stop it!
But they haven't made that rebirth. So, anybody else got a hot take?
Off subject.
Off subject. What do you got?
We had WWE tickets left over. No one grabbed them.
For what?
Sunday.
For WrestleMania. Who had tickets?
PLR.
No,
you had two left over. Read your emails.
Are you trying to break Kendall and Rebecca up right now?
No, Rebecca. Kendall was in New Jersey Sunday.
No, we were actually back.
We didn't have WrestleMania tickets.
Read your email, bitch.
We have Sound Tiger tickets.
No, they,
same thing.
The past weekend, there was two leftover WrestleMania tickets.
Hold on.
Rebecca.
Rebecca's about to be so mad.
Rebecca is dead inside.
Yeah, right? You slept through WrestleMania anyway.
You weren't going to go to New Jersey.
She would have.
You know, I'll tell you something.
He was in Philly. How would you go to New Jersey?
She would have gone on Saturday.
No, they were for Sunday.
There is a gay hockey player, by the way.
It was a girl.
No, there's another one I found. Fuck you, I'm drunk right now, okay? Leave me alone.
Read your email from last Friday.
I looked, I didn't see it.
Brendan Burke is his name, by the way.
Oh, he played for the Flames.
I'm telling you.
Did he play for the Flames?
If
I told you.
Everything's right in the world.
If Kendall...
I told you.
If Kendall could have had two free WrestleMania... I think
he
Rebecca
also died at
21,
so shut the hell up, you homophobes.
We're just poking fun at.
I've sucked a few in my life, pal. Yeah, we had two WWE leftovers. I'm like, no one wants them.
I didn't hear any contest.
You worked there.
Yeah, you worked there too. It's
yeah, but you're constantly on email. I'm not.
Well, I did not receive that email. That must be not on the all Milford list.
That's really happy for my car ride.
You want me to pull it up? I can pull it up.
Yeah, let me see. Right. Let me see.
I'm happy for this
I'm
car ride home.
I'm not trying to
make
you two fight.
So here's the deal. And I explained this to... We could have purchased tickets. We had some friends go. For WrestleMania...
I'm glad you didn't because it's gay.
For WrestleMania...
Are we still alive?
You know, they play in a huge stadium. The ring, no matter what, is still 10 by 10 or 12 by 12, whatever they want to...
And
know,
I have an issue with that. Did you purchase micro wrestling tickets yet?
That was micro wrestling.
I could get her on the list, though.
It's midget wrestling.
That's funny as hell.
We have a participant in studio right now.
Is it Mike Mock?
No,
it's the gentleman who runs the PPRN radio network.
I'm not wrestling a midget.
We can get you on the card if you want.
They prefer little people.
No, they can't say midgets anymore.
It's tiny person, isn't it?
Yep.
Dwarf.
I feel like tiny person is like more condescending than little person.
I agree.
But I was trying to explain to Rebecca is that the ring is...
Yeah, so four pairs of tickets to Cello's tonight in Mohegan Sun.
Why the fuck are we here? Why aren't we there?
Two pairs of tickets to Mariah Carey tonight at Oakdale. And one pair of tickets to WWE WrestleMania Sunday at the MetLife Stadium in New Jersey.
Like next
Alex
Sunday?
Alex sent it.
I didn't get that message.
To all staff Milford.
Kendall, your grave is dug.
It was at 318 from Sharon Colling.
Miss, you wouldn't have enjoyed it. You know why? Because we would have left there at 12.
I heard
you know,
it was packed.
50, you know, a.m. We would have got back to Wallingford at 7:30 in the morning because the trains start running slower. Metro North stops out of.
You could have slept on the train.
This seems like not show discussion.
It's WrestleMania, so it's kind of show.
WrestleMania is over. It's done. Baseball season.
I was gonna say, why aren't baseball you going season. I see you guys went to Philly. Did I start something?
We went to Philly twice.
I'm sorry.
Mock
Philly,
didn't go at
Philly
all.
Was Saturday.
Rebecca, I would have went with you, but I hate wrestling. It's gay.
I'm about to go a third time in August.
So speaking of gay wrestling, I'm gonna be wearing yoga pants, a headband, and leg warmers.
Have you thought of your name?
Here's
yet?
A hot take for you: the Houston Texans will miss the playoffs this year.
Yes.
No.
So will the Cowboys.
I think they have a good enough team to make the wild card.
Cowboys?
Nope. I think they miss it.
I'm trying to run through the AFC in my head real fast.
Here's the deal. The Texans can make the playoffs if every single pick in their draft goes to the offensive line.
Browns.
If one pick in their draft is not an offensive lineman, no.
Browns.
They have the worst offensive line in football.
Worse than the Cardinals?
Worse than the Cardinals. Worse than the Seahawks. They have the worst offensive line in football.
Browns.
Just put J.J. Watt on the offensive side of the ball. Tell him to be a right tackle. He'll be fine.
I think the NFC, the AFC North has potential to wrap up both wild card positions.
Yes.
I very easily could see Browns, Ravens, and Steelers all making the playoffs.
I think the Steelers win the division this year.
The Colts will make the playoffs.
Gee, I wonder why.
I'm being serious.
No, but I'm just saying the Patriots will make the playoffs. The Chiefs will make the playoffs. The Colts are the better team. The Colts are going to make the playoffs. I think the Colts have what it takes to win that division. Any of those teams I just mentioned in the AFC North have the potential to make the playoffs, and one of them could make a wild card, no problem. Let's not forget the fact that regardless of who the AFC North is or AFC East is playing, the Bills or the Jets, more so the Bills, I think, because the defense is better, but the Bills and the Jets both have they have to play the Bills and the Dolphins or the Jets and the Dolphins twice as well. Like,
I have a question.
What?
If the Chiefs end up moving on from Tyreek Hill.
They already have. They cut him.
When?
Didn't they cut him like three weeks ago?
No.
I saw a report they cut him.
They didn't.
He was on like the trading block.
I'm already looking it up, Mass.
So if he gets moved, do you still think the Chiefs are a lock?
No.
In that because I don't.
I think they're done.
I don't know about them.
Because the defense is very bad.
Well, I just think that kind of makes it more competitive in that division.
Hot take.
And I think that the Chargers are way better without Tyreek Hill.
Hot take.
I think the Chargers are way better now anyways.
The Jacksonville Jaguars will make the playoffs.
No.
Yes.
Here's the thing. Foles will give you 7 games. Is 7-9 good enough to get in the playoffs?
What your defense is going to give you is going to be good enough to get you in the playoffs.
They're
7-9?
What was the Jaguars' record this year?
I don't know.
4-12, I think.
All right, so the defense is good enough to give you 4 wins,
and Foles is good enough to give you 7.
So you're banking on their defense being mediocre in those 7, and Foles' bad games coming in those 4.
Yes.
Okay.
I like that logic.
I still don't think 11 games is enough to win that division. I think the Colts very easily could go 12-4.
Yeah.
I think the Colts could go 6-0 in their division.
Honestly, I think anybody but the Titans can make the playoffs in that division.
Watch out for Tannehill.
I like the mess of logic, because what if the defense won him 10 games, and then it goes, and Foles can win him another 10. So they'll be 20-2 at the end of the season.
I just watched so much spit come out of Kyle's mouth.
You love it.
I swear to God, it was like a stream.
He's a juicy guy. He's got a lot of fluid.
But, hot take. I think the Steelers win the division next year.
No.
I don't think so.
Why?
They're way too bought into Days of Our Steelers right now. I do think that their offense will help them get to probably 8 wins. I don't think that their defense will help them get past that.
Just 8 wins? Do you think they're going to go 8-8?
Maybe 9.
In an era where Mike Tomlin had never finished below 500.
He wouldn't finish below 500.
I'm just saying.
He would finish at 500.
I think the Steelers will still beat the Browns.
I know I've said this to you, Kyle, already, and I don't want you to get mad at me and start yelling. I think this upcoming season, the Steelers are at best a 10-6 team. And I think the Browns win more than 10 games.
I think, here, I'll round this out with this hot take, and then we got to go to break. I think there's a bigger likelihood of the Rams missing the playoffs than the Steelers missing the playoffs.
I could see it.
It's harsh, but I think it's true.
I think it's true, too, but it's still harsh.
I guarantee
you. You are the worst Rams fan.
I guarantee the Steelers.
That's what I'm saying. We had this whole argument about him, like, when the chips are down, I'm a Rams fan. Like, I can bash the
people. You are the worst.
You pick against the Rams every week. Oh, the Rams going up against the Cardinals. The Cardinals are only using Pop Warner players. The Rams will find a way to lose this. Jared Goff has stone feet. Todd Gurley's 80 years old. Our defense sucks. Fire McVay.
Never. We should sign him to a 20-year, $200 million contract.
The Steelers were already without
only $10 million last year.
$200,000 million.
That sounds like a paycheck that comes after drinking private stock. All right, we got to go to break. Kyle, what'd you have? Make it quick. We got to go to break.
All I said was I think the Steelers didn't have Le'Veon Bell last year,
and they missed the playoffs.
Yeah, not because of him.
They missed the playoffs.
Not because of the running back situation.
But the argument you're making is they didn't have Bell, but
they
missed the playoffs.
A better corner than what they had.
The animosity is gone. They still have the best offensive line in football. They still have a top 5 quarterback in Ben. They're going to have a healthy James Conner back. They have Juju. They've got higher draft picks than normal.
What do they have behind Juju?
The Steelers have always been a team.
I'm letting you know, Dante Moncrief is no joke. He played in Jacksonville with Blake Bortles.
And the Steelers have always been a team that have made something out of nothing in terms of receivers.
Yeah, fair enough.
And in the second and third round, they'll draft one, and he'll become a star.
I don't know if anyone else is aware of this, but Antonio Brown was not a top 32 pick in the draft.
No, he was what, sixth round?
Correct. Was he sixth? I thought he was
yeah.
a sixth round
was
pick.
Was he sixth?
He was a sixth round pick.
Oh, Bell was a third.
Yeah, second.
But
the Steelers will find another receiver. They will get a better linebacker. They'll get a better. They'll get better corners, and they'll be
plus.
Fine.
The Steelers also don't know if anybody else at the table knows this. Pretty good at drafting people.
Yeah.
Yes. They'll find a receiver in the draft in the seventh round, and he'll be just as good as Antonio Brown in 4 years. That's just how it works for them. It's how they do things. Just like the Patriots are going to draft another Tom Brady this year. It's going to happen.
The Patriots have traded for Josh Rosen.
By the time we die, the Patriots will have won 40 Super Bowls.
Bill Belichick is going on 162.
All right, we're going to break. We'll come back in 2 minutes. We have another bracket to get to, some NHL talk, all kinds of fun stuff. We'll be back in 2 minutes.
And now, back to Getting Sports with Drunk on the PPRN Radio Network.
Welcome back to Getting Sports with Drunk. I'm your hostess, Cupcake the Riddler.
I feel like I'm on an episode of Roseanne with that.
The hell was that?
Take it from the top. Let's start over.
The hell was that?
That was the closing bumper.
I'm done. I have nothing left to say.
We can play it over
now,
and over again.
Back to Getting Sports with Drunk on the PPRN Radio Network.
That sounds pretty hot.
I don't know what to do.
it would see, you're not listening through the headphones.
Run it again!
He pointed.
No, I know, but right when he pointed, it played it again. Like, I don't
and
know.
Now,
it played twice.
Back to Getting Sports with Drunk.
Oh, yeah, it is. His fault.
Radio
I'm not doing this. This isn't happening.
Why don't you wear the headphones?
So, because they hurt my ears.
Run it back
no,
again!
No, they hurt my ears, like, pushing against my ears. My ears are very close to my head, and they push in too far.
It's
and
called wax buildup.
No, it's not wax buildup. I clean out my ears with hot baby oil every 3 days.
He really does.
Not,
it's kind
of weird. I hear perfectly because of it.
Run it again.
Anyway, so we have a new bracket, and it is the best of Souls' nicknames.
Uh oh,
the spitter.
I was actually able to come up with 16
love
comic names.
There.
So, Kyle,
you didn't do bracket break though,
because we didn't have to break from anything.
All right.
I just farted.
Kyle.
Yeah.
This is all you, bud. 1 through 4, pick a quadrant.
2.
All right. The number 1 seed, Classic Souls. Going up against the number 4 seed, Souls A.
That's what I said, Ryan. Hot baby oil. That's just weird.
Souls.
It's not weird.
Souls.
The hot baby oil goes in and it breaks up all the wax and it causes the wax to float to the top of the baby oil. And then you tilt your head and it all pours out.
And you see all them yellow bumps coming out?
No, because I clean them regularly.
Walker did a very good job of cleaning your ears, too.
Yeah. All right, so Souls versus Souls A.
We're choosing the one we like more?
Yeah.
Souls.
Souls.
Souls. It's classic. You know?
Souls, as Ferrazzi called me.
Soul yells.
And then in the same quadrant, we have the number 2, K-Quick Souls, versus the number 3 seed, Toothpick Souls.
Toothpick Souls all the way.
K-Quick Souls.
I think I go Toothpick here.
K-Quick.
You always have to be the deciding factor, by the way. You know that, right?
They're so good.
So, as you got to think back to your lineage, you know, Toothpick was classic. Those
Toothpick
gangster scenes we used to run.
But but that was a self-assigned nickname. I gave you the nickname K-Quick Souls.
Come on, Kyle. Move it along here.
Nicknames by law cannot be self-given.
All right,
they have to be given by somebody else.
Go.
Wait, what?
Kyle, just say a name.
What are you guys doing?
Just say a name.
We got a bracket going.
Okay.
Toothpick.
All right, Toothpick, moving on.
Kyle has a lot of nicknames, so we're deciding who's
the
best nickname of all time.
What are the choices?
One. All right. So the number 1 seed, Milwaukee, versus the number 4 seed, I can't remember. Solidus.
Milwaukee.
That's one, right? Solidus, isn't it, or something like that? Or Solzus, that's what it is. Solzus.
Milwaukee.
Someone calls you that.
Probably Jeff.
Yeah, I'm going with Souls. All right. And the number 2 seed, Mojito, versus the number 3 seed, Yoshi.
Oh, Mojito.
Mojito
Souls. All the way.
Yoshi.
Yoshi.
Kyle, you hated
no,
that
Kyle,
name.
You don't get to go last.
Yeah, you don't get to go last.
All right, fine.
Or you have to go last. Mojito.
Why is Burger King putting bacon in everything all of a sudden?
McDonald's
always is
America.
Because McDonald's. We were bacon before McDonald's. All
right, Souls, 3 or 4?
So impassioned.
Three or four. 3 or 4? 3? All right. Number one seed Brother Souls versus the number four seed Smelly.
Smelly.
I voted for Brother Souls. Smelly, it's funny, but...
Smelly was around for a while, but Brother Souls is one of my favorites.
Virginia's winning 32-29 at the half.
Yeah, I'm paid for 70 points.
All right, so Brother Souls wins?
Brother Souls wins. All right,
number two seed, Man of Many Names versus the number three seed, Poochie.
Wow. Man of Many Names.
Poochie is too new.
It's a new one.
I haven't even heard that one yet.
If he was black, Poochie would be
good. So for the listeners, when we go on the car rides to the
Shut
games,
up, Fat Bite!
We play the name game, which, you know, you pick a sport, and you can do all-time act or whatever, yeah. But it's just like, so say you start off with Alex Rodriguez. The next person has to pick a baseball player whose first name starts with R. And you keep going back and forth.
Yeah, okay.
We started doing this on the Philly trip last week, not on Saturday, but the week before, where we did made-up names. So you just came up with a name, and you had to create a personality and a background for this person. And Kyle created Poochie. And right before Poochie, I created someone named Philip, or what was it? Oh, Donald Phillips.
Donald Phillips.
Which was like a 600-pound fat guy that like lived in his recliner and like heavy breathing. And so I kept interrupting Kyle as Poochie, and he kept calling me Fat Boy. And then that turned into a two-hour thing on the ride there. And he does the Poochie persona perfect. But anyway, so...
Looks like a drunk Uber Poochie. Driver right now.
I'm voting Poochie.
Man of Many Names. Kyle, again? Do not vote.
You know, Poochie is fresh in my mind, so I think he wins.
I'm going Poochie.
All right, Poochie it is.
Shut up, Fat Boy.
It's so funny.
It sounds like the poor man's Mr. Chow.
He does have hair like a collie.
The number one seed, Gilberto, versus the number four seed, Nat King Souls.
Oh, Gilberto.
I love them both, but Gilberto is a classic.
Gilberto.
Nat King Souls.
He hates Gilberto, too, don't you?
Fucking hate it.
Yeah, but he hated Yoshi, and he voted for it.
All right, the number two seed, K Souls Capone, versus the number three seed, Super Duper Kyle.
Super Duper Kyle, I'll be famous for a while. Yeah.
Mute his microphone.
I'm going with K-Souls Capone.
K-Souls Capone.
K-Souls Capone.
K-Souls Capone.
Super Duper Kyle, I'll be famous for a while, yeah.
Kyle has voted against everything gone through.
So, number one seed, Brother Souls versus number three seed, Poochie.
Brother Souls.
Brother Souls.
Brother Souls, because it's the longer standing joke at this point.
That's stupid.
Oh, we used to do a lot of Brother Souls. Brother Souls, preach for us.
In the name of God, Brother Souls takes you from the hands of God.
What? In the name of God, I take you from the hands of God.
I got a beer coming.
Number one seed Milwaukee versus the number two seed Mojito.
Milwaukee.
Mojito.
Mojito.
Milwaukee.
Milwaukee.
Oh, Mojito is one of my favorites.
Yeah, Milwaukee is my favorite.
All right, number one seed, Souls, versus the number three seed, Toothpick Souls.
Souls.
Toothpick Souls.
Toothpick Souls.
Souls.
Toothpick Souls.
Oh.
Over your own name?
Yeah.
Wow, Souls is the best nickname.
It's not as fun.
Yeah, but Souls works in so many capacities. Think about how...
As evidenced by this bracket.
Would you be able to have as much fun with music if his name was Toothpick Souls?
No.
All right, so then fuck off. Number one seed Gilberto versus the number two seed K Souls Capone.
Gilberto.
Gilberto.
Anybody else?
Say, I'm sorry.
Gilberto versus Capone.
Oh, Gilberto.
Gilberto.
Gilberto sounds like a sandwich.
Gilberto's going to win.
Number three seed Toothpick Souls versus number one seed Gilberto.
Gilberto.
Gilberto. I hate Toothpick Souls.
Gilberto. Yeah, hey.
And number one seed Milwaukee versus the number one seed Brother Souls.
Milwaukee.
Brother Souls.
You know, I'm going to vote for Milwaukee here.
I'm voting for Milwaukee.
All right.
All right, so we've got Milwaukee versus Gilberto.
Milwaukee.
Gilberto.
Gilberto.
Milwaukee.
No!
Kyle?
Gilberto.
Milwaukee.
All right.
The fans have voted. Eric Hansen says, not many places make mojitos, so Gilberto wins.
I responded with, Souls is the mojito master.
Super duper.
How did Mojito get started?
We were in Pittsburgh.
Yep.
We were playing a drinking game.
Yep.
And Kendall had to rename everybody as a different beverage. And he coined Kyle Mojito. And then we forced him to drink a mojito at the casino, and he hated it.
Mojito. It wasn't a real mojito.
No, we're not going through this.
There's just a couple that I'm interested in.
This is not sports related.
Who cares? You did this.
This is off the air. All
right, hold on.
Take the board.
They want to know about me, so let's go.
Tell me about Brother Souls.
That started at pickup basketball at Community Lake. Kyle just one night decided that he was going to be Brother Souls and started preaching to us.
Trump Nixon.
I forgot about Trump Nixon.
Me too.
That's not a nickname, though. That's more of a persona.
Tell me about Gilberto.
I don't know where that one came from.
Gilberto, because he has Mexican qualities.
That was a Jeff Martin and myself type creation. It's just us saying Gilberto Souls over and over.
All right. Tell me about Toothpick.
He created that himself in Hamden.
No, I was at the Pacific Buffet.
Oh, yeah. Amen. He always takes a toothpick on the way out. And one time he just sat in the car the whole ride home just going, yeah, see? And then just started calling himself Toothpick Souls after that.
All right. Tell me about Yoshi.
Jimmy Thomas.
Yoshi's the oldest one besides Souls, right?
Yeah, Jimmy Thomas back in Little League called me Yoshi.
And Kyle hated it.
Him and Brandon Trumpled. I hated it at first. Then I embraced it as I got older.
Because Yoshi's green.
Yeah, it's also fantastic.
Tell me about K. Souls Capone.
I don't know.
Kyle just said that one day. Very similar to the name for the show. So he called himself K. Souls Capone.
I think it's older than that.
That was the same with Nat King Souls.
Man of many names.
No, Nat King Souls, because we were listening to Nat King
on the show in Hamden. It was playing.
No, that was on the way to Hamden. He came up with that name because we were listening to the Christmas song in October.
I think it's self-explanatory, but Man of Many Names.
Yeah, you just couldn't think of a name, so we just called him. Kendall said, well, you could be the Man of Many Names.
Lump sum name.
I'm the Man of Many Names.
All right, and I think, did we already say what K-Quick Souls came from? You said you gave that to him.
Paul, that was a Paul original. That's the only one on that board that I gave to him solely, and it was because we were sitting in his room. Soulsley, sorry. We were sitting in his room, and he got up really fast because he had to shit, and he was about to shit in his recliner.
And he was like, wait until the last minute.
But then he shit so quickly, and he was just like, wow, that was the quickest shit I've ever. And I was like, it's because you're K-Quick Souls. Aww. And he just liked it. He liked the name.
K-Quick Souls.
I always thought that it was off the old wrestler. K-Quick.
Oh, you mean R-Truth? No.
All right, and that's the end of the nicknames.
It's just shout out your favorite nickname.
There's nobody else that we know that you could do 16 nicknames with.
Penis.
And if we really sat down, we could probably come up with a couple more.
Obviously, Trump Nixon, didn't you say?
That's a persona. That's not a nickname.
You all think that.
Coach isn't a nickname either. Coach is a person.
Coach. Kyle, show the people Coach.
Let's build a wall.
It's the best.
All right.
So let's talk a little NHL.
I disagree with that, by the way.
Let's talk a little NHL. So we kind of dove into it a little bit. So there's two things I wanted to talk about for the majority of this segment. And that is,
dude just mashed his balls on the back of that chair.
Back of my body. So the NHL playoffs are starting April 10th. So we've got the Tampa Bay Lightning versus the Blue Jackets, Bruins Maple Leafs, Capitals Hurricanes, Islanders Penguins. And then in the West, we've got Blues, Jets, Stars, Predators, Knights, Sharks, Avalanche, Flames. So I think there's a lot of intrigue in this playoffs. So we're going to do the playoffs will start before we're on air.
Mm-hmm.
But I wanted to wait until tomorrow when the NBA is finally wrapped up. We'll do our annual NHL and NBA brackets.
Yep.
That we'll print out and see who gets the closest.
Which is usually none of us.
And we'll have to talk next week about how we finished point-wise for our NCAA brackets. Yikes.
Thanks, Duke, North Carolina.
Message for me?
Kyle and I got the
whole show.
Really?
But I just think there's a lot of intrigue in this. I think that there is a case for any one of these teams in the East to make a playoff push deep in the Eastern Conference. I think the only team that doesn't have what it takes to make it all the way to the Eastern Conference Finals is the Hurricanes. I think that they are playing good hockey as a team. I just don't think they have the offensive power to outscore any of these other teams. The Islanders have always been known as an offensive juggernaut that gives up a lot of goals. The Penguins have spurts of that as well. The Capitals have arguably the best goal scorer of our generation. The Toronto Maple Leafs are a well-rounded offensive unit. The Bruins are a very well-rounded defensive unit. And you have the best team in hockey versus a star-studded lineup in the Blue Jackets.
I just want to ask you, Eric on Facebook is asking, what do you think of Jonathan Quick? Where it is they may be thinking of trading him?
I think that the Kings are just absolutely just beside themselves in terms of what to do. I mean, they fired their coach. They just announced, I think it was yesterday, that the interim head coach would not be welcomed back.
Yep.
The team is frustrated. Players are starting to speak out on social media against other teams and things like that. I think they finished dead last in the league, if not, or dead last in the West, one of the two, but either way. The Kings have been the team. They were the team for the first stretch of the Blackhawks' time. Like, it was Blackhawks and Kings. That's how it was going. And then the Kings won the Stanley Cup, the Blackhawks won the final Stanley Cup, and then it kind of shifted, the power shifted to the East.
Yeah.
And then it became Capitals Penguins. There's just a lot of work that needs to be done on the Kings. They have a lot of talent, but their youth is not where I think they want it to be. Their farm system right now. Jonathan Quick is one of those players that you can get a lot of return for. I think that even though they will have a good draft pick, they could get two top 10 draft picks.
Yeah.
Dealing Quick, I could see them getting maybe like the 10th or 11th pick for Quick and maybe like a third rounder or something like that. Because the first picks, the top 10 picks is a lot. It's like the NFL draft. It's a deep draft, but
how many rounds in the NHL draft?
I think it's
roughly, if you know off the top of your head.
I think it's 10.
Oh, okay.
I think it's double.
So a lot of picks.
Yeah.
A lot of picks,
but there's a lot of people to choose from.
Yeah.
And you got to figure the NHL versus the NFL. If you're the worst player on a professional team, you're on the fourth line. The fourth line still sees ice time.
Yeah.
Whereas, like, if you're the worst player on the NFL team, you might be special teams or not play at all.
Eric on Facebook is agreeing with everything you just said.
So I think the King, like, you know, as a Blackhawks fan, you know, I've been bred to, like, you know, I'm supposed to be bred to hate the Kings because of recent, like, Western Conference, like, back and forth.
Yeah.
But I don't dislike the Kings. I think the Kings are a very talented team. I think the Kings were, the years that they beat the Blackhawks, they were better than the Blackhawks. I was heartbroken when they lost it in overtime that year when they beat the Rangers. But it's one of those things that the Kings, much like the Blackhawks, they're suffering from finally having cap space issues due to these star players. They don't have the youth to back up the depth because they're paying these star players like the Blackhawks. They're paying Taze, they're paying Kane, they're paying Seabrook, paying Duncan Keith. They don't have the money to go out and get average to above average role players. Yeah. They're basing it off of the development of youth. And the Blackhawks are a team that have always, just like the Kings, have always been very good at developing their youth. But when the time comes for them to re-up on a contract, they don't have the money to give them. That's what happened with Panarin with the Blackhawks.
Yeah.
And they traded him to the Blue Jackets. Panarin's going to get a payday this offseason. A big-time payday.
So as you're breathing right in the mic.
So it's going to be...
Get over it.
I wouldn't be surprised if they got rid of Quick. I would be hesitant to do it as the franchise because he's not right now what he was when they were in their Stanley Cup prime. But he is still a once-in-a-generation goaltender.
Yeah.
He is, ha-ha, he's quick. But he's got absolute he's got absolute lightning reflexes. He can read the puck off of a stick instantly. I haven't seen a goaltender in the league when he was in his prime more able to just... The puck doesn't even leave the tape of the stick yet, and he knows where it's going.
Yeah.
He's made ridiculous save after ridiculous save. I would be very hesitant because it's a hard thing to regain, but in terms of the collateral you can get for him, it might be worth it because they're gonna start doing this rebuild thing.
Yeah.
Do it and trade for Fleury.
No. That would be absolutely absurd. I would be very upset if that happened. But I just, you know, we'll talk more about this next week. The week after, once the playoffs are kind of underway.
Right.
And, you know, these guys have kind of seen what teams are picking up so that they have something to talk about. Like, oh, yeah, they're up 3-0. I think they're going to win it. That's the kind of analysis we'll get. But it's better than nothing.
Because right now we have a whole lot of nothing from us.
Did Seth Rollins just lose?
Hold on. Undertaker's coming out. So who cares? He's 900 years old.
Triple threat match. He wins both belts. No, but the one thing I've actually been intrigued about, they've been talking about, and Red Baron brought it up last hour. They're talking about doing they want to do like re-segmenting, not the NHL in general, but there's been a lot of talk about redoing the NHL playoffs.
Yeah.
So they want to do it, some people want to do it more similar to the NBA playoffs, where it's the top 8 teams make it, not the top 3 in each division and 2 wild cards. Because for a long time, it's been the 2 teams, it's been the 3 teams in the Central Division for the West, and then the other 2 teams. It's been like the Blackhawks, Predators, the Blues, and then the Wild, and then like the Stars make it.
Yeah.
You know, it's been like that for a while. And a lot of teams, you know, there's a lot of people that want to see just the top 8 teams. If it's all the teams in the Central, then they all deserve to be in there. Because you see a lot of times, like, you look at, you know, like, they didn't make it, they wouldn't have made it anyway, but like, the we talked about the Canadiens, like the 15th best team in the NHL, and they missed the playoffs.
Is there any other sport that does it that way?
Some people want to do it regardless of conference. They want to do it where the top 16 teams make it. If the top 16 teams are in the East, it's like all having a vagina. I don't like that. I like that East-West thing, like it's been in the NBA. It's like the AFC-NFC, NL versus AL. I like that breakup of it. I don't think it'll ever change, but it's interesting to see the way it's going. They do it right now the way that the NBA does it in terms of bracketing. So it's not the best seed will always play the worst seed. It's geared up so that the best seed should play the worst seed. Throughout, if the one, 1, 2, 3, and 4 all advance, the 1 will play the 4 and the 2 will play the 3, and then the 1 would play the 2 or the 3. You know, and that's how the NBA works out. But I kind of like it the way it is. I like the wild card aspect. It gives more excitement, and it gives Stanley Cup matchups that you're not always attested to seeing. This year, it's not going to really work out that way in the West like it has in years past, but it was exciting in years past when you'd see the Wild and the Sharks.
Yeah.
It's not something you'd really see
different
in a
matchup,
lot.
Yeah.
Yeah. No. So that's my
there's no here. There's no other sport that does it that way, though, is there?
Well, the only other sport that could do it would be the NBA, and the NBA just does the top 8. The NBA still, for whatever reason, unbeknownst to me, still has divisions, which doesn't make any fucking sense. Each conference has 3 divisions, and it means nothing. You can have all 5 teams from 1 division make the playoffs. You can have no teams from a division make the playoffs. So what's the point?
Just make it the top 8 and be done with it.
Just make it an Eastern Conference and a Western Conference. I mean, and the thing with the NBA is they
does it have to do with rivalries? I don't know how.
But it's not even like rivalries. I mean, like the Celtics and the Lakers are rivals. You know, like the 76ers are rivals with the Pistons. You know, they have that history. It just in the NBA they play the season out where it's like you play the teams in your conference like 2 to 3 times, and you play the teams in your division 3 to 4 times. But why do you play the teams in your division more than the other teams in your conference if those win losses don't mean anything extra? If it's just 1 win or 1 loss, why bother?
Yeah,
it?
Right.
I think that if they're going to do something where the divisions matter, they need to reseed it so that there's 4 divisions, 2 in each, and do it like the NHL does. The top 3 in each, 2 wild cards, something like that. But other than that,
would you be in favor of doing the top 8 teams from each league, as it were?
What?
Like you said, do it from the AL or not from the AL, or from the East and West. Would you be in favor of doing the top 8 teams from each rather than the wild card?
That's what they do.
No,
the NBA playoffs are set up that the top 8 teams.
I'm going back to hockey for you.
No,
okay.
That's the Mike Bender.
I like the matchups of. I like the matchups that you don't get to see it as much. I like seeing the 7-game series between, because like yes, the Wild will play the Sharks more than the Wild will play the Bruins, but they're not going to play them more than they're going to play the teams in their conference.
Yeah.
And then to see 7 consecutive games, you know, it's like in the MLB. It's, you know, if the Mets make the postseason and their first matchup is against the Dodgers, yeah, they play the Dodgers in the regular season, but not enough to like make it like it's a gimme thing for either team. I like the excitement of having the random-ish type matchups, and that's why I like the NFL. Like I like the NFL type of thing, because it's very probable you're going to play a team in your conference in the playoffs that you didn't play that year.
Yeah,
like it's probably more common than not that you're going to play a team you didn't play. So I don't know. I'm not. It's just like a stale thing, and you see it in the ML. You've seen it in the MLB. I feel like more so in terms of speeding up the game. I get that the aspect they're going through, but I feel like it's like a stale thing. They just move from league to league, and it's just like, all right, like, we haven't really changed a lot of impactful stuff in a while in this one. So let's, like, NFL was like that for the past, like, 8 years. Now the MLB, they're like, pitch clock. Oh, you know, do we want, you know, automation behind the plate? You know, things like that. You know, let's change. Let's get rid of the DH. Let's do it where, like, if you come in, you have to pitch at least three batters. Or you have to finish the inning, you know. And then it'll move on to the NBA. And then it'll move back onto the NHL. And then it's just, like, it's like a staleness. And it's like, don't change things because you're bored. Change things that need to be changed.
Yeah.
If it's working, don't break it to fix it. It doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
So
I agree.
The NBA
Eric,
thing,
can you clarify that a little bit?
In terms of the playoffs, the only thing the NBA really needs to change is they need to get rid of the divisions. The divisions, they just don't mean anything.
Yeah.
Make them mean something, or make every team play all, make one team play all other 14 teams in the East the same amount of games. Because it matters. You playing the Cavs four times as a Bulls fan means nothing more than the two times you might play the Heat. You should play them both three.
Yeah,
yeah.
Because you have to beat both of them to get up to the 8 seed or higher. So it just doesn't make any sense.
Yeah. There's a disconnect there for sure.
Well, and then you look at a team like Indiana, for example. Indiana, even though they lost Oladipo, they put enough wins together to stay in the 5 seed spot. But they were playing against what is the 8th seed Pistons. They were playing the bottom-ranked Cavs. They're playing the Cavs and the Bulls, two teams that are going to finish in the bottom four of the league.
Lottery teams.
Right. Like, high lottery teams.
Yeah.
So, you know, like, they didn't really necessarily, you know, they had to play those teams a lot still. Make it even. It shouldn't, like, they had a more gimme schedule than, like, say, the Celtics did.
Right.
You know, the Celtics still had to play the 76ers. The Celtics still had to play the Raptors. They still had to play the Brooklyn. Playoff teams. Outside of the Bucks, the Pacers, without Oladipo, are still, in my opinion, a better team than the Pistons. And then they had to play the Bulls and the Cavs.
Paul, question for you. Mm-hmm. Eric on Facebook is asking. He's saying that on NHLs.com, all the staffers are saying that the Capitals will win the first round of the playoffs, but no one is picking them to repeat as champions. Agree or no?
Agree. I think the Capitals have... The Capitals are going to beat the Hurricanes. I would be willing to bet money on it. I just don't think the Hurricanes have the offensive firepower to last the Capitals in seven games. But I think the Penguins are a more clutch team than the Capitals. The Penguins have gotten a little hotter. The Islanders are a very offensively explosive team. An off night for them can very easily be three goals. You know, that's that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And then even if they get through that, they still have to get through the Lightning or the Bruins or the Maple Leafs, whatever team. I just don't think the Capitals have it this year. I think they started off the season with a little bit of championship hangover. It carried through. Then they got hot again. They ended up clinching the one seed in their division. I just don't think it's the same Capitals team. Like, the underdog mentality. Not the underdog mentality, but
kind of like the snake bitten thing. You know, they made it so many times and couldn't push through. And then they finally did.
Yeah, it's I don't know what that snake bitten thing is. I've never heard of that. But
you ever heard that?
No.
It's got like a cursed type, like,
what, now that they win it, they'll never win it again?
No, I mean, like,
that was always their drive, is that they were that snake bitten team that they,
a team, you know, that could never make it. You know, they're always in the discussion. And
the Dodgers. The Dodgers are snake bitten.
But they didn't win it.
Exactly. So, like, that's like a driving thing for the, so, like, the Capitals, how many times did they win, like, the President's Trophy and lose in the play? But they finally got over that hump and won a Stanley Cup. So they no longer have that drive of, we haven't done this before.
Right. Okay. I get what you're saying. I guess the only team really that has that drive is the Lightning.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I don't think the Capitals have what it, I don't think the Capitals are the best team in the East. And I think that there's at least three teams in the West that could beat them.
I have a question for you, kind of spinning off of that.
In my opinion, it's just not the same Capitals team. It has nothing to do with, like, now that they've won it, they won't win it again. Because, yeah, like, they don't have that driving, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, professional athletes, they still have the same drive. I mean, now that the postseason's starting up, last year's Stanley Cup means nothing. You know, it almost will feel like salt in the wound if they don't do it again, type of thing. But I just, they're not the same team. I just don't think they're the same team. That's all it is, in my opinion.
I'm looking at a lot of these matchups, and a lot of the matchups, one team is either kind of like swept or won big, for the most part. And I was curious, in your opinion, in using your knowledge, How much of that weighs into the playoffs moving forward?
What do you mean they're sweat?
So I'm looking at the season matchup. For example, the four games that Washington and Carolina played, Washington won all four. We have the regular season Lightning Columbus, Lightning leads 3-0 on the year. Same deal for the Flames versus Colorado.
So, I mean, but you're pitching wild card matchups. So they're just a better team.
Right. I guess I'm just...
Like, if you told me, if you came into it and you were like, oh, okay, like, Winnipeg swept the Blues, that's a big deal. If Winnipeg beat the Blues all four times, the Blues never won a game, that'd be a bigger deal because it's a two seed versus a three seed. But you're talking about, like, the Lightning versus the Blue Jackets. The Blue Jackets were a team that all season long were not up in a playoff spot all season long. So, and they're going up against a team that won 62 games in a season. So that's like, it's like having like.
So it's really not like a big deal.
No, it's like having Orlando facing the Bucks. Like, no, I'm not surprised that the Blue Jackets got swept by the Lightning. The Blue Jackets are still a very good team, and I think that, you know, if they get hot, they could stun the Lightning. They have a lot of talent, especially after the trades that they pulled. And not to mention the talent they already had on the team, but it's just... The biggest thing for the Blue Jackets, I think, that's going to get in their head is that, like, everyone in the Blue Jackets is putting so much pressure on themselves to win now because they know they're not going to have two of their star players next year. So it's like, if they don't do it right now, like they're probably not going to be able to do it for at least another couple of years. So those matchups, like the Flames and the Avalanche, no, it doesn't make a big deal. Predators Stars would be the only one I would say that make a difference. I think the Stars, you know, when healthy, have a very... They kind of had some issues after the trades that they got with Zuccarello and all that. Like, it just didn't work out. So, you know, Zuccarello got injured in his first game as a Star. They hit some hiccups here and there. That would be a more intriguing matchup. Right. But, like, well, I said, if it was a 2-3 seed, and, like, if you told me the Bruins swept the Maple Leafs, like, yeah, that's a big, that would play into it a little more. But hockey, unlike any other professional sport, especially in the postseason, it's the only sport where really the actual phrase, a lucky bounce, counts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, I understand, like, if a running back fumbles a football and it hits the ground and bounces out of bounds, like, oh, yeah, they got the lucky bounce or whatever. But it's like, the turnover, it doesn't necessarily, unless you fumble the football and it takes a lucky bounce, you pick it up and scoop it and run it into the end zone.
A lucky, like, bounce in hockey is a goal.
Yeah.
That's a scoring play.
Right. And it happens all the time. I can't tell you how many times you watch a game and you see a defenseman load up a slap shot from the blue line, and the player that redirected it in was a defenseman trying to block it, and it went off of a stick and went up over the shoulder of the goalie, and he had no chance. It happens all the time.
I've seen that a lot more than I thought I would since I've started watching hockey.
Well, I mean, you're stopping something that's a third of the size of a baseball going 110 miles an hour, and you're trying to block it with your body, and you're just not going to be able to move over fast enough. So it's any team can win.
Right.
It's all about the lucky bounces. And the lucky bounces, you know, if the Avalanche go in and they win the first game because they played hard and surprised the Flames, and then they get a lucky bounce, you know, off, say they just send a puck in off the boards to clear the zone, and it takes a weird Kareem off of a stanchion and goes into the goal. Now they're up 2-0 in that game, and then they end up winning it 2-1.
I didn't
know
they have half a word that you
now they have all the momentum in the row, 2-0 with two road wins going back to Colorado, and that one lucky bounce. Sure, it's a very specific circumstance, but
it changes a series.
It changes everything. Series. Now and then you look at it, it's like you see it in the NBA. Kyle, how many times have you seen a road team in the NBA wins the first two games? Now it becomes home court advantage for the lower seeded team. Your goal is in a lower seeded team, hockey or baseball or basketball, or even baseball.
Baseball too.
Win a game. Win one
you
of the first two road games. Go 500 in the first away series. Then you have home advantage at that point. So
now I'm not sure how does the split work in hockey? Is it like 2-2, 1-1-1 or
I think it's 2-2, 1-1-1.
I think that's it because I know baseball is like 2-3-2.
Yeah, I think NBA is. I think NBA and NHL are the same. I think it's 2-2, 1-1-1. Kyle, it's not 2-3-2 anymore, right? It's 2-2, 1-1-1.
For baseball?
For basketball. The NBA is 2-2, 1-1-1, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. It used to be 2-3-2. And then they stopped doing it because if you went 500, you now have three games at home.
Yeah.
Like, you now have got home court advantage, essentially. So, yeah. And I don't know. I can't remember if the NHL used to be 2-3-2 or if it was always 2-2-1-1-1. It sucks because I like the 2-2-1-1-1 because it keeps true home ice advantage for the team that earned home ice advantage. But because you look at some of these things, like, you look at, like, just look at Nashville-Dallas. It's a long commute for one game.
Yeah.
You know? Or you look at it when you get to the Stanley Cup Finals and it's like Boston versus the Kings or something like that. Like, that's a long fucking commute for a game.
A series takes 3.5 years to finish.
Yeah, exactly. That's why the NBA and NHL playoffs start April 10th and finish in June. That is what it is. Souls?
Thanks, Eric.
Yes, thank you, Eric. Thank you for the input. We like it when people...
Eric's been in it.
Good.
He likes me, too. That's what's important. It's very important. He says my name.
Souls?
Sup?
There's 1045 banter.
How many games are the Phillies going to win this year?
13. 94.
Who's going to have the best record in baseball?
By far the Mets. Let's go.
In May.
Hey.
I don't know who's going to have the best record in baseball this year. Because I'm still like...
It's not going to be the Dodgers.
I still refuse to believe the Red Sox are not going to turn this around. Like, they're going to figure things out. But has enough damage been done, you know, early on where they, you know, they...
Isn't it the curse with this year?
Hmm?
Don't they have the curse this year? Something with the Red Sox or something?
Good night, Eric.
But they've won like three. Right. So the curse is kind of like over. Huh? Well, they had a curse because they hadn't won one in like a century, but then they won three. So the curse is like over.
Hasn't it lifted though again or like came back or something?
They just won it last year.
Yeah.
Well, this year could be the bad year.
That'd be awesome if it was.
Could be a comeback.
Red Sox.
Best record.
Fuck the Red Sox.
Yeah, you think the Phillies have the best record in baseball this year?
No.
Who do you think has the best record in baseball this year?
Dodgers.
You think so?
Yeah.
By how many games?
2 or 3.
Who's in second place?
A lot.
I think the Astros can make a case.
Souls, we'd like you near the microphone if that's possible.
Yeah, I'd like to... For you to fuck yourself.
Kyle, you know, I ran into you on the way to the bathroom for a millionth time, as that's what I do, and you look like you've done cocaine for 18 straight hours.
Yeah.
Going on hour 19, baby. I think the Astros can make a run. I mean, they're the team, they're solid all around.
Except that starting rotation.
Last?
Best team in baseball?
No. Do you even listen to the show?
No, not really.
Who do you think is going to have the best record in baseball?
What did I just say?
Who's the best team? No. It's not the same thing.
It's what I meant.
You know what sucks? If I said the Yankees, Kyle would have jumped at me. But he was allowed to say the Phillies.
He didn't say the Phillies.
That's right, he didn't. He said they would win 94 games.
Take a shot, bro.
No, because you also yelled at me because I said the Yankees would win around 95 games. I didn't yell at you.
I said I don't think they're going to win 100. Shot, bro.
No, you're wrong.
You guys all haven't done one all show.
That's not true. I did a shot earlier.
I know you have. I'm not blaming you. I like you.
Thanks, Souls. I like you too.
You know what this means?
That'll change tomorrow.
Around the horn.
I'm sure.
Because you won't answer him when he texts you.
That's not true.
Yeah, that's it's very probably true. Very true.
Yeah, no, Mass didn't answer us for like 3 days.
Mass is busy.
Yeah, around the horn, all of us.
I can't look at Rebecca.
Best team in baseball, the Rays.
No,
who's best record, baseball, Rays.
Around the horn,
God, I'm not drinking that.
Oh my God, you're such pussies.
I think Milwaukee puts up the best record.
I was going to say the same thing. I think this is a year, like a big push through.
Milwaukee Souls.
I think the World Series, but I think it'll be one of those types of things. They'll put up the best record in baseball, and then they'll lose in like
around the horn.
Everything seems to kind of be clicking there right now. I think they kind of build on that momentum, especially from last year. They put together, I mean, we'll call it, I think it's a potential of like a 100-win team. You know, we'll call it, well, let's say they go 103 in whatever.
They have no pitcher.
Kyle? You're right. They don't. But they also, but unless the Cubs turn things around, they play a lot of average teams.
Right. But I think the Cardinals are a better overall team.
The Cardinals.
What?
They're always kind of in there. I agree.
They're always middle of the pack.
Watching. Yeah, well, not even that. You know,
they'll figure it out, and the Cardinals will be a 92, 93.
The Cardinals have a history of that. You know, they have these pitchers that they draft or who they sign, and they just they go off.
We're a very homegrown team.
Homebrew team.
Matt, Devin Bush to the Steelers, right?
Yeah,
that's right.
That's Matt's right.
Better text all.
I like him today.
Yeah.
Kendall, you're on the horn, bro.
I didn't receive it.
Too far away.
It's too far. I'll catch it on back the around. I'll catch it on the rebound.
Kyle.
Mock.
Kyle.
Nine till Mock takes it.
Kyle, I'm not drinking it, so.
Kyle.
You can get as mad as you want.
What's the NBA Finals matchup? Toronto Golden State?
No, Milwaukee Golden State.
Machine?
Milwaukee Houston.
Is Toronto Houston possible?
Yes.
I don't know the divisions.
Yes.
Connecticut Sun.
I was so worried about your driving.
And Baylor. Seattle.
Do a shot.
Seattle Storm.
Don't give it to him.
Give me it.
Take it away.
I'll take it.
This is so awesome. I agree with Mark. Milwaukee,
you're really kindling
Houston.
Things right now. Looking for the loose beer. What'd you get?
I said Milwaukee, Houston.
Is that just because you're a Houston homer?
Yep.
Yes. When are you going to pick the Rockets as your favorite team? You're not a Knicks fan.
This is dumb what's happening over here. Sheamus and Cesaro ran out and broke up the match.
What match?
Seth Rollins and Kofi Kingston.
Knicks, I don't want Kofi to lose.
So dumb.
The bar.
You're not a Knicks fan. Can we? All right, here's my last hot take before we get into beer reviews. Kendall Reed is not a Knicks fan.
Facts.
I am. Listen, here's the deal.
You're not.
I like this.
Is he a Knicks fan the same way that I'm a Raptors fan?
No.
I like the city Houston a lot for many reasons. I like the culture. I like the music. I like the sports teams. There's a lot of history there.
Chingy.
Chingy's from St. Louis.
You know what?
I like that entire culture.
You know why
culture.
I don't believe you?
Was he a member of the St. Louis?
Pick number 1 through 32.
Interestingly, yes, but he actually has a beef with Nelly, so they kind of split. But he was kind of like originally, yes.
Chingy Nelly beef?
Hold on.
Air Force.
So I'm kind of curious. Why is he picking a number?
Because he's not a Knicks fan.
You're not a Knicks fan.
It's a team I would support. Look, here's the deal.
No.
Does he have any Knicks gear?
The only reason you are a Knicks fan.
Not anymore. The jersey doesn't.
And it was a Stephon Marbury jersey.
No. It was Carmelo Anthony's shirtsy.
The only reason that you're a Knicks fan is because the Knicks have the best history in the NBA of having ridiculous players that are bad.
Listen, is that a contributing factor? Of course it is.
It's the factor.
Can you explain that a little bit?
I like that a little bit more.
They have a lot of players that are really good other places and not with them.
Oh, so somebody will show up, suck for them, then go somewhere else and rock out?
Or they'll be above average for them but better elsewhere. I mean, we could literally just list off hundreds of players.
I like that kind of
you
stuff.
You don't, though.
What do you mean? I don't.
You're
you
not a Knicks fan.
Pick a number 1 through 32.
No, I'm not doing that. Listen.
When's the last time you watched a Knicks game for your own personal enjoyment, start to finish?
Not since I was, back at Bailey Ave with Jeff. So
have you watched any other basketball games for your own?
Not counting Jeff, just you. Jeff can't be involved because Jeff's a Knicks fan.
Well, then never. Because
have you ever watched a basketball game for your own enjoyment?
No, because I started watching, the Knicks, with my friendship with Jeff, and it was kind of like a mutual interest because I like the Mets. I like the Steelers for an outside reason rather than locality. You know, it's the whole thing.
Why do you like the Steelers?
Because you wanted to be Jerome Bettis.
A big Jerome Bettis fan.
He wasn't a Jerome Bettis fan. He wanted to be Jerome Bettis.
He was the coolest running back at the time.
He wanted to be a fat black guy.
He was a cool running back.
Bus. Kittle, pick a number 1 through 30.
I can't be a Rockets fan for the reason I can't be an Astros fan. Or
next week's Twitter poll.
Who should Kendall be a fan of?
I won't support that.
You're not a Knicks fan.
I'm a Knicks fan. Listen.
You're not.
All right, hold on.
Listen, I have to ban all because that makes me a Houston fan entirely. But I like the Astros.
You should choose the Astros over the Mets.
Hold on. Souls.
But I shouldn't.
I'm kidding.
Souls, I'm going to pick three numbers for you.
I'll support your Mets fandom because you can name me so many Mets.
I got to hear
you. But you can't name me many Knicks that weren't just terrible people.
Well, I can't. I can't. I can.
So here's what's going to happen. We're going to name three numbers.
I bet you could name me more Rockets than he could Knicks right now.
Probably. So speaking hold on. Go ahead. So Mock, Riddler, and I will each name a number. That'll be a team that sells picks. That'll be the Twitter poll next week.
No.
I don't even know what any of that means.
He's not gonna pick. He's not gonna do. But he's not a Knicks fan.
Speaking of Twitter poll, I've had this one. Since I think it's for like check? 2 weeks.
The check.
Posted it while I was there. So I asked.
Should you?
I posted it on opening day.
Oh, okay. So baseball.
Yes. I asked who has the better season this year. Bryce Harper, Aaron Judge, Mookie Betts, Mike Trout.
I'm surprised you left
Soul's head just flipped up so fast.
I'm surprised you left Machado out of it just because of like the signing stuff.
Yeah, it was only one. You can name. Only do four options.
Only one name.
Bryce Harper.
No. Mike Trout. Mike Trout will have
What did the Twitterverse say?
Well, I don't know if you guys wanted to weigh in.
Who has the better season? Like for individual,
better season this year. Better individual season.
For individual purposes? Mike Trout. I think that Bryce Harper has the more successful season. Or I could make the case for Harper or Judge.
Okay. So I'm gonna go from the lowest to the highest. We had 17 votes.
Nice.
Coming in last with 0%, Bryce Harper.
Wow.
That's stupid.
Coming in third with 18%.
Mookie Betts.
Coming in second.
Mike Trout.
With 35%, Mike Trout.
And how many times did you vote?
I only voted once.
How many fake Twitter accounts you got?
Judge came in first with 47%.
Which is bullshit.
I voted for Judge because I'm a Yankees fan, but I do think it's going to be Trout.
Yeah, by far.
The funny part is Bryce Harper got 0%.
Because all your friends are stupid.
It's not my friends' count. People that follow us are count.
Does he have more home runs than any of them right now?
Yeah. He had more home runs than Judge.
Even after Saturday?
Yeah. Yeah. Judge has one home run.
He had another one today, so he has two.
So Harper has three, right?
Yeah. But I don't care about that.
I thought Judge had two the other day.
He had one.
Did he?
No, Sanchez had two.
Either way.
Sanchez had three.
If you're an asshole, you pick anybody but Trout.
The only explanation I can think of is...
They're Yankee fans.
No.
They base it off of team.
Here's the thing, though. Like, a legitimate argument to not pick Trout is he gets hurt a lot.
Sort of Judge.
I know, but Kyle, stop taking it so personally.
I'm not. I'm letting you know.
Trout gets hurt every single year.
I think the bigger play on it is team. Is that...
Yeah, that too.
Granted, the Phillies are going to be a better team, but the Red Sox just won the World Series, and the Yankees were very close to being the team that was in the World Series. So, like, people, I think, were, like, more apt to picking Judge and Betts. I know Betts finished third.
Yeah, I gotcha.
Like, people pick Trout. Like, baseball fans that are doing it off individual purposes pick Trout, but... People who are thinking in terms of like, well, the Angels fucking suck, so I'm gonna pick Judge.
They do.
What, they're the best player in baseball by far.
Well, not according to our Twitter followers.
Is Mike Trout gonna have a better career than the kid?
Yeah,
you think so?
Mike Trout's on pace to have the best career of all time,
and he won't make the Hall
he's
of Fame.
He's not all around. Like, he's an all around better hitter, and he better on the base. He's better fielder.
Trout's not gonna make the Hall of Fame.
I think he's
gonna get in a DUI accident with a bus full of children.
That doesn't matter.
If he is hammered and knocks a school bus off a bridge killing 35 kids, I don't think he'd make the Hall of Fame.
Well, that's a big difference.
Tell you what, if he gets in after that, we better let Pete Rose in.
Yeah. If he makes the Hall of Fame after doing something like that, Pete Rose better be welcomed in with golden roses.
Especially because Pete Rose was a bus driver that day.
Paul, how was your Red Dog?
Oh, just fucking phenomenal.
I love this beer so much.
I mean, I won't give it 5 stars, and that's why I didn't put it in the journal, because I would want to.
You know what's funny? I, too, didn't put mine in my journal.
I put mine in the journal.
It was more just because we were talking.
You don't drink any good beers.
I drink good beers.
You don't.
I do.
You don't.
The Red Dog is the best beer staple. The show.
And this, I did give it 5 stars.
Tell you what.
Did you?
I did.
You want to know a fun fact about the Red Dog?
Highlight 5 stars.
I haven't had highlight from the show.
Fun fact about Red Dog.
You've never had a highlight on the show?
Not this show.
Today? What do you mean?
This was the first beer I ever had on our show. When it was me, you, and Kendall in the living room on Maple.
I don't remember the living room show. Did I get hammered?
It was the three of us,
yep.
and at the time, it was Rebecca and Michelle night. Watching us. And we talked about the Falcons-Seahawks playoff game for an hour. Kendall said, you got to watch out for CJ Procise. Boy, was he wrong.
I remember that. 100% remember it now.
Hey, guess who didn't play that game?
CJ Procise.
Guess who wasn't injured?
You know who would say something like that? Procise. A Houston Rockets fan. Let me tell you that. All right.
We have Red Dog first.
Yeah,
first.
I just think that Red Dog is the most like crushable beer.
But
it's flavorful.
It's got a flavor on it.
It's got like the...
Tell you what, they get worse as they warm up, though.
No, yes. I disagree. I just think that like they have like that body you're looking for in a shit beer, and they're like not too filling, but they're filling enough. You could be good with 4. You could be good with 40. Like, and the price is right. The price is right. Saw a shirt in Philly. The price is right. Wanted to buy that.
Fuck you. Apparently, Mike Trout just robbed Christian Yelich of a home run.
Christian Yelich sucks. So.
Also, fuck you.
Kyle, how was your beer?
You like Christian Yelich?
I do.
Kyle, how was your beer? Well, he was almost a Philly.
No.
Yankees in 4.
This is my second favorite beer of all time.
What, Red Dog?
Nope. Juice Boost.
I can't believe he liked it.
So you like this more than Too Juicy?
Yeah, a lot
more. So you don't even actually really like Too Juicy then?
I do.
Nah, because I've heard you say you like 6 beers more than Too Juicy.
I could see why Kyle would like this beer more than Too Juicy.
It's so flavorful. Doesn't really taste like a sour.
It really doesn't.
It's a really good beer. I have like half left if you want to try it.
Let it go, Paul.
Dude. I would like to try it.
Yeah.
Is it so cold or not really?
Very.
Very not really cold?
I said very.
Social media, Mark.
Yes, listen. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Getting Sports with Drunk. Twitter is GSWD_4.
Make sure you use the hashtag GSWD, whether it's not knowing anything about beer or like just being an asshole and rooting for the Knicks for all the wrong reasons.
Subscribe on Podbean, iTunes, Google Play, and iHeartRadio, and Spotify. We're on the PPRN Radio Network every Monday night from 8 to 11.
Ish.
Ish, yeah. Be sure tomorrow night, Kendall and I will be on the, and Rebecca, will be on the Peter Pino show, 7:30 to 10:30 here on PPRN. Check it out. Coming soon, we'll be posting our show from Litchfield Distillery, whenever Rebecca decides to finish that. Taking her sweet time over there.
Well, production director. She really gets in the way, but she could have gone to WrestleMania until 4 in the morning, and that would have been okay.
But, we got some, hopefully get into another brewery somewhere soon.
Rebecca just wants to go to WrestleMania because she thinks she can get slammed by Seth Rollins. It's the only
Whoa.
Well, Kendall's not a Knicks fan.
The Knicks. I like all of Houston. Everything that accompanies it. I would have rooted for the WNBA team when they were there.
Imagine if the Knicks moved to Houston.
Go Comets.
By the way, next week, very big show.
Good one next week.
It's our NFL.
Yeah, so you can elaborate. Big show.
I was letting Kyle do it. He was just.
We got Wayne Knight coming on.
I was getting to it.
Wayne Newton.
Big Newton.
Next week is our NFL draft show.
Mock draft.
Kyle, it helps if you say it into the mic.
I'm gonna punch you right in the
fucking mush.
So next week we're doing a full NFL first round mock draft show. Maxine Washable, the Mass Chris Massey, and Milwaukee. We'll be doing...
Do you have to remember which one won?
Yep. They will be doing a live draft on the show. So there will be, pick steals and whatnot. We're not just going to be presenting each one's individual mock draft. Also, I know Souls and I have already completed a full 32-pick mock draft. We might do more. We're not sure which one we sold on yet. Mass, did you finish one yet?
Yes, sir.
Is it the one you're going to submit? Not sure. So that'll be a competition we have, a friendly competition we have on the show. All submissions must be in by Tuesday at midnight.
I'm going to do a mock fourth round. Only the fourth round.
I want to do a mock draft.
And guess what?
everybody's sliding to the fourth round.
You know, Riddler,
first overall pick in the fourth round, DK Metcalf.
Riddler, that's a good idea. A Mike mock draft. I don't know what it would entail, but you know, you have the perfect name for this type of situation.
Drafting,
you know,
beers.
It's funny because when I swam in high school, we would do like the mock meets, and that instantly became Mike mock.
Yeah.
Your friend, well, Carl.
Can you come up with a concept, you know, we'll or anybody?
When your beer journal is full, we will do a Mike mock beer draft. A beer mock draft. Beer Mike mock draft. A machine washable draft.
All right.
So yeah, make sure you tune in next week. Big show. Red Baron and I will be providing analysis of picks and all that fun stuff. Kendall will be Mel Kiper.
Kendall needs to dress like Mel Kiper, though.
He is Mel Kiper. And Mel Kiper's not a fucking Rockets fan.
I'll try to do a Widow's Peak or whatever he has.
Do you know what a Widow's Peak is?
It's kind of what Jeff has.
Wow, that was fucked up.
No, all right.
So
until next week,
I'm your hostess, Cupcake the Riddler.
It is what Jeff has.
I'm Mock.
Sheen Washable.
Nope.
I'm Milwaukee.
The Mask, Chris Massey.
And I'm the Red Baron.
Yeah.